Right, welcome everybody once more, and for the last time, done it, we're finally in the finals. Gunrunners and Five Kings did it once more, both landed in the finals just last season. We both, or we all three, hope it's not gonna end like 3-0 like last season. I'm joined by our lovely guys Keizo and Mac. Hi guys.
Hello.
Alex, we just talked some stuff through and try to decide who starts which map. And again, Five Kings look so, well, some would say confident, some would say cocky. And they don't even want to knife on map, they just pick a map, we're gonna destroy you anyway. What are your thoughts on that?
There's a lot of drama for sure.
I think Five Kings are very much very confident, as you said, run at your team. It's gonna be interesting to see if they approach this final the way they approached their game with Team Winners, where they just went all
ready
out
up.
Aggression
nice.
And ended up just essentially steamrolling them. But will they give Gunrunners in this game a bit more respect and maybe sit in a bit more and not go so gung-ho, so to say? I think that's going to be an interesting way to see how they start this game. But I think for most people that do know Five Kings, I think they're probably not going to change. I think they're going to start pretty quick. It's going to be interesting to see how Gunrunners deal with their fast pace of play.
And you also made a little bit of a prediction that you thought... I mean, is Crossfire the first map, by the way?
They're just knife for it. The original best of five rule that there's a knife, the loser or when I'm not sure, bans, the other team bans, and one team picks, the other team picks, and there's one decider, which is being... I just had to mute my... Sorry. And... if it's 2-1 for either team, like the last two maps which have been vetoed in the beginning have then to be picked again by knife. So, kind of complicated, but we'll see Five Kings taking the knife, so they have the first ban, apparently. And now, okay, the loser's banned. Okay, so that's clarified.
They remove backbots, it seems.
Yes.
Alright, well, if the maps aren't decided yet, let's just wait with the predictions until
yeah,
we know which maps
course.
Are being played.
I'm loving the shit talk going in already. Our Five Kings trying to ruffle the feathers of Team Gunrunners. They seem to be looking to get a reaction, and they're not necessarily getting it at the moment. The Zoomer coming out of a very English phrase, "Are you dizzy, blood?" as we'd say over here in London.
Gunrunners usually not the types to flame, I think.
Yeah, definitely not, but if it's coming so hard in from Five King, they're gonna react to it. Okay,
no one can avoid the flame from Dex and Azuma.
Another Vito's cross. Jesus Christ. These guys are so trolling.
I'm glad they've opened up this fire, to be honest. It's at least making it a very exciting start, I think, the first round. It might be a good idea to watch maybe some of the SMGs, see what they're doing, if this is going to be really fast-paced. I think it might be more interesting than watching the scopes, who might need a few rounds to kind of adapt and adjust to the pace of the game, and they might get in their flow then. So I'm not sure who you guys would probably think to be a good SMG to follow. Who do you think is probably the best person?
They're really all on the same level. CD is, in my opinion, the best one, but it really depends on spawns, on the map, on the daily form. So the only one I would pick out was CD.
I mean, okay. Is it the Gunrunner specifically, or are we talking in general?
In general.
I was talking in general, yeah.
I think definitely watch out for Azuma. I mean... Azuma and Dex are the type of guys that can really bring their A game when they're needed the most, I feel like. So I definitely think Azuma on the SMG. I think Azuma is playing SMG, right? So I think if that's the case, definitely Azuma is someone to watch out for. And CD, as you say, as well, really good player.
I think what's going to be also interesting to note is that Five Kings were regularly switching up the weapons in their game against Team Winners. Are they going to do that today? Are they going to stick to their main weapons? I'd expect at certain points on maps like Backlot that yes, they will change weapons on spawns, but regularly across the different maps, I think we saw, didn't we, Goatee, that they were changing weapons frequently. So it's going to be interesting to see if they choose to do that against a team like Gunrunners, who we should also point out actually lost, who they lost to 2-0 in the pay-to-play league before the finals. So definitely, Five Kings have definitely got something to prove here. Their only loss was against Gunrunners.
Yep.
So yeah, I think they're going to come out all guns blazing.
On the other hand, Gunrunners has lost quite a few games against other people, which Five Kings just destroyed. So yeah, I'm really curious about this one.
But that's the thing also when you're talking about the very experienced teams and especially online matches, you usually have. I mean, you can just, if you look at the CS:GO, the major CS:GO teams like NIP, for example. They can lose against, I mean, the most unexpected teams online, and then they go to LAN and they just absolutely destroy them. And I think there's, I mean, when you're a really established and good team, I don't think you get the same thrill from playing teams that you know are way below you. So despite Five Kings destroying some teams that Gunrunners didn't, this could go either way, I feel like, because these are two really good teams, and the whole game just changes once two good teams collides, basically.
Sure, but we thought the same stuff last season. Gunrunners also took a map to the ladder phase from Five Kings, but got absolutely dicked in the finals. I think it was like a 45-minute game or something. Unfortunately, I couldn't cast it, and nobody else was around. So that was quite depressing, so we made sure we could stream at this time. But yeah, I mean, we just go like this again, but maybe CDE brought his notebook out and heavily counter-stratted Five Kings. Are we going to see some perfect anti-struts? That's what I'm hoping for.
Yeah, well, I think Crash is a very good map to open up with. I was either hoping for a Crash start or a Crash final, personally, because what you can guarantee with Crash is it can either be very close or it can be very quick. And from what we saw in the last game between Team Gunrunners, oh no, sorry, Five Kings and Team Losers, was that it went very quickly. And I think Team Gunrunners would have made a note of that, and they will possibly be sitting back and prepared for the AK aggression and SMG aggression that we'd expect from Five Kings. So very, very exciting start here. It'd be interesting to see what side they get after the knife. I'm personally hoping that Gunrunners get the defensive side, because I'd like to see them go ahead in the game. I think most people will agree that the defensive side is stronger to a degree. And if they were to get a few rounds ahead, I think that'd be awesome, just for the excitement of this final.
Yep, sure. And one fact is known, that Gunrunners have nades. This was like the worst part of seeing Losers getting dicked by Five Kings. They had no nades and they peaked like retards. But this time we surely hope they're gonna stick in and concentrate more on the game, because Gunrunners really want revenge. I know they're pissed on Five Kings because they're errant decks, but if you're that good, you kinda are low to, aren't you? Okay, let's start with the knife. It's just for the side, but yeah, as Mac pointed out, it's kinda important. Crash. Five Kings decide to hold the A side. Kinda lame tactic coming in, and let's see. Out, relax, holding one entrance, just waiting for any Gunrunners playing in. But Johnny is taking the second frag already, but it's getting taken out by the leader. Got his second as well. So, leader got his third, so let's see if we can make it an ace. Oh, but Relax already stays, and Johnny calling out that they're going deaf. It's CD in a 1v3, and he doesn't even get one, so early call, no luck.
Let's see, I want to call it now. Let's see if Five Kings have the arrogance to call the attack and just do it. You'd expect they might just leave it as is. Well, sorry, leave it as is. They are currently sitting on defense. Will they have the arrogance to go over to defense or over to attack?
They do have the arrogance, but they don't want to waste time. Their heads is like, oh, I have to sit in front of my PC and kill some noobs again and waste time on my life. But yeah, so they might be arrogant enough to that they can win anyway, but they just want to end this quick.
Yeah, I think that's definitely a very good point there. I'm really, really hoping that there's some good early nade frags from Gunrunners and they use that to their advantage here. If not, then yeah, it could be a steamroll. I hope it's not another 3-0 like it was in the previous game. Also, if there's anyone in the chat that's got any particular predictions, then please let it know. We might discuss anything that you put there.
Yeah, we've already seen some people posting 3-0 for Five Kings, 3-0 for GRS, and even some people, the GRS magic, and we all hope that they're gonna show some tonight. Players already. But yeah, post your predictions, really wanna see. Probably because of the delay, we will be live, so glad we don't post out your prediction. I'll be sure to be active in the chat to discuss with each other. Loving to live.
It's also gonna be interesting seeing this match. Usually, there's only one, maximum two. Of this caliber, matches of this caliber per season, so it's definitely not every day you see this type of match being played.
Definitely.
Yeah, I mean, I think everyone in the community was probably glad when the seeds changed and it ended up providing the route for Five Kings and Gunrunners to get themselves to the final.
Look at the defense spawn. Five Kings already warming up like a football team, building a circle. That's what the team spirit is all about.
Yeah, they look confident here. They definitely look confident. I'm really intrigued to see if their gameplay changes. I really don't think it's going to. Totally trolling. Love seeing a bit of this. I think, as I said before the stream started, I'm really interested to see how Dex gets into the game once he warms up. It often takes the scope a couple of rounds to warm up.
Alright, we are live. Good luck and fun. And Kezo, why don't you take the first?
Absolutely. Let's go ahead and follow Dex then, see what he does here with the scope. Pretty defensive play from him right now. Let me just turn off the volume here so I can hear something. First frag goes down. CT onto Relax and Deleter with the Deagle onto Glady. So it's a 4v4 situation. Make that a 4v3 as... Whose turn?
It's SMG.
Samuel G takes down CDE. Jenny onto with the reply frag onto Samuel G. Not quite sure what's happening here right now. It's very. Neither is working his way down the B long with the bomb. He has the scope and an AK in his hand. And Jenny is just making his way into the hardware garden, managed to find a frag on Dex. And let's see here, Jani. Oh, he did actually hold the cross there, but Deleter and where do we have Izuma on the site? And Deleter is basically stuck on backyard. Izuma is gonna connect with three Gunrunner players anytime soon. There we go, nice play from Neither there from the roof. The bomb site is secured. Deleter is the last man standing, and there we go, Neither. Really nice job from Gunrunners, and especially Neither there, grabbing some important frags for the first round.
Lovely round by Gunrunners, really loving this slow pace but still aggressive play, and they pushed forward, they were looking for the frags, and Five Kings didn't even offer them, but they just fought for them and found them as well, so... The player, let's see if this happens again, where are the... This time they're heading to A, so Jenny already behind the generators, and Gladdy with the other SMG on T-wall. To offer some execute, just hiding for players with the flash coming out and the nade onto root. Double flash into A with nades combined, it seems. So, if a flash would hit a player, they would be too blind to move Get killed by the nade. Love this execute, never seen it. And Johnny finally takes the first frag out in back A, but there was no smoke up, so Dex easy frag onto him under the bomb. And Gladi got a bomb down, killed Uzuma just after planning, was really lucky, so it's only Dex and 1v2. They of course slowly move middle, but there's already player T-ball. He has a clue there's a player around there. Surely gonna hunt him for you. Okay, but he doesn't check top blue. He had the right idea, but he didn't check it, but he's going another way and still checking it and even tagging up CD, but not getting the frag. And CD, yeah, if you don't kill me, I'm gonna kill you. A lovely second round for Jiro.
Yeah, absolutely perfect start here. I want to move on to the SMGs on the GRS side, so let's move on to CDE and see what he's gonna do. This kind of slow gameplay seems to be working. It's not what was working for Team Winners, but Jiro seems to be using their experience to do very well. I also did get that wrong. CD's playing AK this game. I think we all expected he was playing SMG beforehand. But we do have some possible success in on A here. They seem to have moved in and they're planting the bomb. CDE's failed his jump, unfortunately. He thinks someone's low A and he was correct. He gets dropped by Samuel G.
Whoa.
Glad he gets small bang. This is a really, really big frag for Team 5 Kings. They're going to smoke the bomb and they expect that they've got someone either in blue or near spawn house, which is correct. We've got Dex who's trying to pick him out and they're going to seek to defuse the bomb shortly. Explosives and Dex, fantastic kill onto neither. Great gameplay from him, good support for his teammate who
only got attacked by well, defusing kills would have been sorry, unfortunately.
I think what we can say after the first couple of rounds here is that Gunrunner's just getting the feel of how 5 Kings are playing. First two rounds they played a little bit slower, just tried to get the peaks, and despite getting peaks on the B side there, they just kept on playing slow to see what 5 Kings would do. Now the third round, you saw we saw a little bit more faster towards A. So I think that's how it's gonna go now. They're just gonna give it a couple of rounds to get the feel what 5 Kings are doing and then adapt to it.
Oh, they were successfully feeling it.
Let's see here, it's not looking good for Gunrunners so far this round. It's a 4v3 situation right now, CD and Glady down for Gunrunners, but Sko has made his way down bottom A and grabs a frag onto Samuel G and makes it a 3v3 situation. He has one more to go on the, I think it's on the wooden stairs, the other guy here. Let's see if Sko can spot him on wooden. He does spot him. Misses a couple of shots though. Ooh, very close. And I believe neither is also making his way with the bomb into bottom A. But 5 Kings are closing in on backyard. It's gonna be hard to get the bomb down, but Sko with an 8 frag on Uzuma on wooden, and it's possible to get the bomb down now. Both Gunrunners, Gunrunner players on the side, but a couple of frags in the leader just pushes up and takes down both neither and Sko.
Got huge. He was doing this in the last game, Deleter. He was making the rounds that come very close count. I'll leave this round over to Goaty. Who do you think we should follow, guys?
Let's have a look. Relix has been not so active thus far. He's on 1-on-3, so let's see what he does. He has a few players coming his way on BLE, I think, but they're playing with two guys actually on the defense. Let's watch the BLE player with Isgem SamG. He actually spotted two players already, but still hiding behind the lamp. Oh my god, and now he's going in for the kill and gets a double onto Gladian CD. Smart play by him. He didn't go for the first kill and just waited for another and tanks up the scope as well. So, could have been a 3k for him right now, but Sko finally gets one frag back, but it's only onto Neither in 1v4, and SamG is hungry for a 3k. He's hunting him down, and Neither can't connect any frag and just gets taken down by the leader. So yeah, good stuff for 5 Kings.
Yeah, I'd like to go into Neither now actually and watch him, see what he's looking to do at the start of the round. I think it's now's time the scopes are gonna possibly finally have a bit more of an effect on the game. He's got, like, so he's done a fast nade into back A. He's going to check the B alley slowly. It doesn't appear that he's going to see anybody. Let's see how he's going to try and help his team. So he's peeking sandbags. He's looking on also mid roof. Playing a quite a reserved game actually, neither. But Team Gunrunners seem to have steamrolled this round. They take control of A. They're looking to plant the bomb, and the round's over very quickly. So Neither was absolutely not the right guy to watch there.
Yeah, for sure, Casus goes.
I definitely picked the worst person. So very interesting timeout called by Dex. Something that some people would have definitely not expected coming out of Five Kings. They obviously appear to be less confident than they are traditionally, because they're simply not up the, like, with the rounds that they probably expected. I'd say they expected 4-1 or so by now.
Well,
what's your guys' opinion?
Yeah, this could be the case, but I can see Uzuma not moving, so it might just be, hey guys, I've got a call, somebody's at the door, just call a quick timeout or something. So they're already readied up again. I think this was quite a bit too short for a tactical timeout. I think they would have talked more if this would be the reason.
Okay, well, in that case, I'm going to professionally go and take a quick piss, boys. I'll be right back in about 1 minute.
What?
Is there any info if this was a... Oh, it was tactical, I presume, since Five Kings are readied up. But it looked like Five Kings came back the last few rounds a little bit. But maybe they felt like they needed a timeout to discuss things even further, to grab the last few rounds of the half.
But they're readied up after 1 minute, so this seems really way too short for a tactical timeout. I just think Uzuma had a phone call or something and came back really quick. So
it could be that as well.
We'll never know, but yeah, we have some more minutes as a break, as neither is doing the same what Mac is doing right now. He's so excited they had to go to the toilet. So we are loving this. So I'm really loving it that it's so close already, and Gunrunners taking already as much rounds on this map on attack that losers did on defense. So really loving it early on. Let's hope it continues like this. You're my turn.
Sure, let's see. Oh, Dex has a good spawn on B-Long. See if there's a scope duel on B-Long. There won't be a scope duel. Neither, nowhere to be seen on B-Long. So let's move ahead towards the A side here. It looks like a pretty hard A push from Gunrunner's Glady. It's in bottom A with the bomb, gets taken down by the Legion. Third frag this round. Wow, absolutely.
Wow.
Fourth frag there on the bomb carrier coming up the
stairs. He's getting the ace.
What did just happen?
Well, I think we know who we're watching next. Straight back to the leader, guys. I think this is Goaty's round.
Yeah, for sure. But I'ma go with neither, actually, because I don't think Gunrunners will do the same mistake and just push in like chicken without a head. And Casus Curse, neither is dead. So let's switch to Glady, who's actually pushed down Bialy already and is already on the bomb. C stacks. Get some bullets out, and he's desperately asking for help by his guys, because he has B on lock, kinda. But he, of course, has no bomb and almost no teammates left, so yeah, he's just waiting for any silly peek by Dex, but we know him. He's actually gonna go to scope house, gets tacked up by the Deagle, but only to 60%, so not in the hat. Glad he survived the scope shot, luckily, and just pulls out the smoke now, so Skull can come in with a bomb. He's going for some silly peaks, in my opinion. He should just go for the plant, because this was their last smoke.
This is really bad play from Skull. They had the smoke down.
But the Lady, on the other hand, is doing the good play and pushed Dex in scope house. And does he suspect Zuma there in scope house as well? He does, and he does get a frag on the attack, down to 40 HP. And Skull now in a 1v2 situation, and the leader, of course, closing in so they can sandwich him, but it's going nice frag onto Uzuma. So he has only the leader to find, and he does it. Lovely clutch of him. We just flamed him for being stupid plays on B-Long, but he has the confidence, he has the aim, and he shows it in the end.
Let's go on to Samuel G for this round. Try and give everyone some time. So he's gone into low hardware. He hasn't expected the quick nade, which he's got away with. He's gone into top hardware. He's going to peek blue. where he seems to be paying keenly, looking for any kind of sound, possibly. He hears someone coming into hardware. Are they going to come up the stairs? I know they might expect a team like Five Kings to be controlling hardware, which they'd be rightfully doing so. So he's beginning to get pushed now. He sees a player, gets a tag, unfortunately. Does not land the frag. And throws a defensive nade down there and a smoke. Keep himself alive and gets wall banged straight through hardware. Absolutely fantastic play there from CDE. So Team Gunrunners look like they're looking to take control of the B bomb site, which they successfully do. And they're 5-4 up on attack.
So clean round as well.
Definitely not the start that Five Kings would have been looking for, and I think all of the people watching are certainly going to be satisfied with the start of this final game.
I just have to add, if you look at the scoreboard right now, it's looking pretty even if you compare the teams. You have CD on top with 10-6, and the leader on top with 10-6. So, I don't know, CD isn't playing SMG, so you can't say it's an SMG battle, but AK versus SMG right now. Let's see, a couple of frags for each team going out. 3-5 King players still alive. Let's see, let's go. And Janny, last player standing. Janny with the frag onto Samuel G. And Gunrunners are making their way down on the B long area with let's see, Sko has the bomb. He's just gonna play watch across from A. Finds a guy on the red car there, tags him up, and there's a guy on the arches there. Janny's trying to get the flag, but the leader somehow dodges all the bullets. Dex gets a little bit ahead of himself there. Janny takes him down, and it's all up to the leader now. Let's see what the leader does. Yes, the SMG. He's pushed all the way to bottom sand. And was really low HP there, but Reg's back up, and he's got two players to go through and a bomb to defuse to win this round. He's gonna go for B long drop, it looks like. He does!
Janny with a lovely 4k.
Yeah. Is this Gotti running this one?
Yes, it is, but it's still Gotti, so thank you. let's watch Sko. He's been the clutch player of the round before that, but he hasn't gotten too many frags yet. Well, as I just said, he's on 10 like the other guys on top, but he's not been that impulsive as the other one, so let's see. He's going in first as an AK, that's really unusual, but yeah, he's not going up first at least, I think, because two SMGs are behind him, which are running away. I don't get this. They make a play on A, they have lower A under control, but they don't dare to go in. Okay, let's see what they play on it. Deleter taking out Janny, or Janny took out Relax, so one for each team, still down to a 4v4. And Sko just chilling bottom A, not so exciting. Let's see, Dax is looking for some frags, wouldn't find any. Yeah, they're just avoiding each other right now. Really passive forward. Look at Azuma, he's back A behind the fence. The leader's holding back A on his own. If somebody would do the jump, I think. Oh, no, Azuma would see that, I guess, on his position, so he should be safe. Let's see if Sko can do something. He's slowly creeping forward. But I think there's a duel in the middle now. CD with a deleter. Deleter is. Samuel G is kind of stuck in middle, and now he moved towards A while deleter took out Sko on bottom A. So they got that cleared up, and the B push is coming in from Gunrunners right now. Glady is already by the scope house, tags up an SMG on A. They have a player to find in scope house, but right now they don't care because they got a bomb down, so now they have the advantage, but only don't do a 2v4. Finally, neither gets a frag CD as well, so don't great do a 2v2. Really great play by Gunrunners, but unfortunately, neither just died, and Sam is going real, and that's coming too late from CDE. He fails to jump as well. So good retake by Five Kings after losing the B-bomb really dramatically.
Yeah, I just have to say there, I did spectate Dex that round and missed a couple of frags on the SMG who pushed on the B-site there, and that's the type of things Five Kings can't afford in a match like this. And he is doing pretty well though, Dex, but that could have cost him the round. So I definitely need to step up a little bit there.
Yeah, certainly. I think we spoke earlier as well. We expected Azuma to be on the SMG, right? And he's sitting on sandbags currently playing a very reserved game. Just looking at bottom A. Gump a very quick round coming out here. Actually quite hard to cast. We've got Azuma who's just taken the frag.
very quickly.
That happened in seconds, yeah. Very, very quick round.
But I did must say...
Sorry, continue.
I must say, when we... I just said that Dex needed to step up a little bit after the missed shots on the B side there. He just absolutely strafed up on hardware and grabbed a wallbang on the top of it. So that was nice. Maybe Dex is hearing us on the stream or something.
Definitely shadow casting us.
He has something removing the delay, so he can spectate.
Yeah, but cool. 6-6, this is not what I expected, so really open game. I hope Gunrunners can take their advantage, which they should have, by taking 6 attack rounds onto defense, and not getting dicked by the aggression which 5 Kings can show. And I think Dex is kind of pissed by this. He didn't expect this being so close. He will really need to step up his game. He might get a little bit aggressive on Relax, who's only on 2 frags. But we'll see.
Relax is gonna take the blame. I just got word as well. Someone wrote in the chat that me and Mac are low.
Super low. Maybe you can turn us up then, Goatee.
Yeah.
You're as loud as my game, so I don't know. But yeah, I will.
Let's see. First round on defense here. Looking good for 5 Kings opening up the A site. CD with the reply frag on the leader though, and it's a 4v4 situation. Lots of 5 King members towards the A site. Let's see. Dex is moving in bottom A as a Relax there as well. Gunrunners. Let's see. Glady is up on the A site defending it. Relax with double frags this round. And it seems like players are stepping up right and left when we're criticized. And wow, Dex with the 2 nice frags there as well. And a really fast round and important round for 5 Kings to get. Attack side is usually considered a little bit harder on Crash, so... Yeah,
definitely.
Very, very good round for 5 Kings.
Really dominating, and Dex taking the confidence I talked about earlier, just pushing into A and getting some frags from there. Let's watch Janio, a good spawn, he's already in A. Defending with an SMG, he has no player in A yet, so... good preposition to hold this, but he's obviously gonna have players watching him in the A bomb, so that's a dangerous position to be in right now. But at least Dex is dead, so he doesn't have to be worried about a one-shot by the scope. He gets tagged up, so a player on bottom A should have heard that he's on top of the stairs, and yeah, he actually bangs it, but can't connect anything. Jenny gets tagged up heavily and even more by the players around B, barely survives with 10 HP. And now the player's obviously moved behind him into A. His teammate died by that, but at least he gets the leader. So he's going for the Deagle Peak on roof, but there's nobody to be found because 2 players are underneath him and the other one is in BLE. He heard the jump and lovely shot, don't you, Relax? That was a nice SMG action by him. So he's still holding A strong, and it's only onto Azuma as Go also got a frag onto Samuel G. So yeah, Azuma stuck in bottom A. Hopes for anybody having a stupid peek, but no, it's not gonna happen. He's just running around, nobody's peeking. They want this round, they're not gonna take any risk. Now he's going for the plan. He's got tagged up through the wall. Bottom actually is allowed to plant, but it's no Counter-Strike. There's no advantage losing the round by planting. Let's see, he gets tagged up as well, laying down on this position, and some more bullets flying on underneath him, and now all 4 players, look at the minimap, all 4 players coming in, he gets the first, gets the second, that's terribly played! Uzuma gets the 4v1, what the fuck?
Terribly played by Gunrunners there, oh my god, huge round what in from Azuma. What the actual fuck? I don't think any of us can have any words for what the hell just happened. I'm going to go on to the attacking side. Deleter looks like he's moving into A. He successfully gets there, although they throw a defensive flash to stop him moving too quickly. He does take a little bit of fire from back A, and then successfully takes down Glady in top A, or Glady, however you want to pronounce his name. It looks like they're looking to get a really quick plant down, which seems very smart from 5 Kings. The Gunrunners team do have someone on Wooden, who looks like he can cause some trouble at some point, but they do look like they've got things locked down right now. They look like they're in a comfortable position. Niva's not having any success on the scope with these wallbangs into A. Deleter's just been waiting, he's been strong all game, very cleverly playing this game. Deleter, for me, I think has been the MVP so far. I think he's played a very smart game, played some very big rounds for Five Kings.
I just get...
Oh, Femji with a pump gun. Value,
yeah, I'm not either, I don't I'm think, not... yeah.
What?
Kezo's turn, yeah.
Okay. let's try to make the best of it. Let's see here. Couple of gunrunners. Brags onto Relax and the Samuel G. And Five Kings are really liking that A side, it seems like, but they are getting stuck bottom A most of the time, and having to clutch their way out of most of the rounds, and I don't think in the long run that's going to hold up, so they're probably going to have to switch something up here, and a lot of Gunrunner members making their way into backyard right now. Uzuma heavily tagged up in bottom A. Janny's going to move around the corner and grab for the first grab. As well. What is happening with this game? And
these
the
huge rounds.
Yeah.
This is absolutely fucking perfect, guys. A timeout called by Five Kings again. They seem to have had their big clutch answered there for a few very quick frags. This game seems to be getting more exciting and opening up fantastically. I mean, Five Kings have started their attack very well. That round from Gunrunners, I think, was crucially important for the game, and they've got it. And let's see if they can get a few more rounds in here and make this map as close as we'd like it to be. Because right. if they fall behind any further from here, then I think they're going to be in trouble, to be honest.
Uzuma calling out a technical pause early on, so no tactical. So, don't know what the problem is, because their pings are right, maybe some voice problems. Not sure, nobody seems to be AFK, so we never know. But maybe they're just calling it technical, because it's too embarrassing to take a tactical timeout against a team who they thought would be easy win. But yeah, after a sick clutch of Uzuma, they felt back confident, and Johnny just said to himself, well, if you can do this, I can do this as well. So he just does it.
Yeah, it was great play. I mean, I think I personally, I'm looking forward to Neither getting into the game himself. When I've watched Gunrunners in the past, he seems to be a kind of team captain in the way he plays. He seems to kind of control the game, and he hasn't done that thus far. And we can also say the same about Dex. I think Crash is very much a map that can be easy to scope sometimes against certain teams, but with the way that both teams are playing, I think both scopes are struggling to establish themselves here, so something to note, certainly. Is it you, Goaty, running through with this round?
Yeah, sure, why not? Let's see, Johnny, who has another perfect spawn onto A, so maybe he's lucky and gets some more action coming in, but after the clutch, maybe Gunrunner, Five Kings, sorry, are taking it a bit slower, and they actually do and take it more into middle. You see a player in short arch already, and so a few players in Crash, but Johnny takes out Sam G with a deagle and is hungry for more, but he will not find more. Actually, he does onto the long arch, but both tag each other really hard. Neither takes out the leader, opening up to a 3v3. So Johnny really needs this kill, he wants it, but here's a player coming in underneath him. So is he going for another peek? Is it going to be a bad timing? He's worried. Nah, he's going for the peek onto the stairs now. Let's see who it is who's pushing him. It is Uzuma. And he obviously knows he's on roof, as he has been fragging his teammates, so he's looking for revenge. CD killing Relax, so Uzuma kinda has to get a frag on roof if they want to get anywhere near to the end of this round as a winning team. Let's see, he's creeping up. He kinda knows the default spots, but he couldn't spot him, so he's not gonna go into the 50-50 decision. Now he does, and he goes up, but he doesn't even get attacked, so good patience by Johnny, who just wandered around. CD killed Stax as well.
Alright, Gunrunners catching up on Five Kings, 8-9 right now. and top fraggers Janny and Deleter. Janny doing really well. He's already on 100 points. 22. He will actually make that 21 to 11 as he takes down Deleter, the other top fragger. And 4v3, 3v3, 3v2 right now. And once again, it looks like a try on the B side on for Five Kings, but actually Dex was on B long trying to get the frag on either, but it's not gonna happen. And see, Samuel G has made his way to bottom sandbags, and it's Samuel G versus Neither. It's a 1v1 situation. Neither is also bottom sandbags, but he's on the other side, and Sam is just gonna try to slow climb up.
Oh,
misses Sam by wow.
Sam is not watching it either.
Oh. Walking with the backs against each other. Neither is now all the way bottom A. And they just keep on missing each other. He's gonna make his way top A. And hopefully for Neither, Samuel G is gonna plant A, but it's not looking like it's gonna be an A because the bomb is on B long. Neither is unaware of this.
Can he make it? He can't make it. There's no way. There's no way.
He's actually going towards A.
Yeah, he had no time to go either bomb side, so he's just hoping for any peek.
No, this is a gun runner's round, yeah.
Wow. So many crazy rounds.
That's what we want to see in the final.
He's got another good spawn, and he's been doing very good with his spawns when he's been going into low A. What I have noticed is that Five Kings nades actually haven't been that fast in on front A. And I say that, and a really quick nade comes in, and Liani luckily just gets fragged. He throws a flash out and he looks into low A, but I think he's just going to establish position on the stairs. He has had a few successes with the Deagle in mid A. Now he's going to roof. He's going to try and pick out some of the Five Kings teams that are sitting within blue. Well, I doubt he's going to see any of them. He does get a tag. I think he got two tags on the Deagle. They're very, very, very unfortunate. A great frag there from Sko onto the Zuma, something the Gunrunners definitely needed to establish the winning round here. And Sko again onto Dex. Gunrunners looking more and more strong as the game's going on here.
Yep, another lovely round by Gunrunners. Let's see if Five Kings want to change anything, but just looks like the same setup. Two knights to A, SMGs are going to A, but they're way too slow. Look at this. Are they scared of nades or any pushes? They're just moving out of blue now after 15 seconds. And we all know you can be there like after 6-7 rounds, but it seems like they don't need SMGs, as Dex just killed two people and deleted a third. So why do you need SMGs in A if you have AKs and a scope who just takes out everybody else? It's only on the Neither and Glady who finally got one frag back into the round. Neither sees a player. No, he just spams the wall. Okay, he doesn't see the player proning on wooden, unfortunately, else he would have been easily spamming him, but yeah. It's only down to Glady, who takes one out, but he has the attention of three players now, and I don't think they're giving him the chance they gave Uzuma earlier, and gets taken out easily.
So close right now, 10-10. And last couple of rounds in favor for Gunrunners. I think Five Kings were in a three-round lead at one point. I think they had 9-6. So well played by Gunrunners last few rounds. And let's see here, yet again. Relax and Uzuma has made their way into the A house already. Relax is making his way top A. Let's see if he can do anything from top A.
Another thing to notice is Relax has actually come onto the SMGs. So they are switching weapons up, as we discussed earlier. Would they do that against Gunrunners? And they have been obviously looking to take advantage of spawns, which is obviously very nice to see.
Yeah, and it's oh wow, nice deagle from Relax there, all the way from top A to sandbags. And Five Kings have cleared out the A side. It's all up to CDE, who is the last player standing for Gunrunners. He takes Dix down, but he's got Deleter, Zuma, and Relax to go through, and a bomb to defuse to win the round, but it's not going to happen. And the 11th round for Five Kings.
So it's getting close. Jiraiya's really need to stop peeking. I don't know how they just let them into A, and then this gold neither stood on sandbags, not aware that somebody could go roof and just gets picked up by a deagle. This shit can't happen. If you want to win a major championship title like this one, you really need to stay in keen, stay focused, and have communications up in your team. As I said, as both teams are getting a frag each, and neither opens up to the advantage of 4v3. Johnny with a lovely deagle tag onto the leader, unfortunately doesn't get a frag. Let's see, he heard a player in bottom A, so he's switching up positions to get the advantage onto him. And while I'm saying this, SamG is taking the advantage to their side as he kills Go and CDE, and now it's Jenny alone in A. And his mate neither has to hold mid and B, as his Jenny is dying as well. So again, the peaks, Five Kings are just waiting and getting those frags, and Samuel G renamed himself to Turret G. So yeah, he just stands in one spot, and if you peek, you're fucking dead. Four kills by him, huge by not moving a bit from middle. So yeah, really need to play to stay in game right now.
I think I'm going to go on to CDE, Goaty. He had a very strong start to the game. He seems to have fizzled out ever so slightly, actually. He is getting frags round in, round out, but he's not particularly making the frags that are winning rounds. And he does get a great frag onto Relax, who was moving quickly onto A. He's holding the mid push. He expects someone from Five Kings to possibly be trying to establish some sort of position of power in Harbour, which they're not doing. Five Kings are sitting back, and they're looking for the frags that they've been successfully getting in the last couple of rounds. I'm going to move on to another player now. We've got someone on Hardware, and that would have been Sko, who's now moved towards the B-bomb. I think that GRS are worried about a slow push possibly down B-alley onto the B-bomb. They're incorrect if they're thinking so, because it looks like Team Five Kings are actually trying to establish a very slow push onto A. We have Azuma, who's moving up into A now, very carefully, and I think playing very well in my eyes. And he seems to know that they've got someone up on the roof, so let's see if he has more success this time than he did last time. And he does. He manages to get the frag onto Janny, which is absolutely crucial to the Five Kings round. He gets taken down. Gladdy with an absolutely fantastic frag, very important. All Gladdy needs to do now is stay alive, but he does get the wall bang, and Team Gunrunners get a round that really was crucial to this map. I think this round is going to be very interesting if it goes into an overtime. I personally think, I was going to say, I think the Five Kings are going to take this round, but neither gets a huge frag onto Delito, who's been playing fantastically for Five Kings so far.
Yeah, absolutely. And very, very, very important round, especially for Gunrunners, if they want to stay alive in this map at least. Let's see, it is a map point for Five Kings. Looking good for Gunrunners though, as Deleter, the top fragger for Five Kings, is down. Make that Samuel G down as well, who was the second top fragger. Or actually not fragger, but score wise, tied with Dex. And Gunrunners playing really carefully here. They really need this round. Janny with another frag on Relax. Yeah, that was a great frag. And it's looking really good for Gunrunners. Let's see, what is Five Kings trying to do here? They have Dix and Asuma, who are both on the A side. But shouldn't count Asuma out. Learned that a couple of rounds ago.
Not again, Zuzuma. Not again.
Grab still at one frag, but neither is there this time to shut him down, and it's 12-12. It's gonna go for an overtime, I believe.
It is.
Yes, I need to set it up.
I think personally for me as a shoutcaster, as someone that's been spectating through the game, I think there's two players, or one player on each team here, that has been very noteworthy of watching. And for Five Kings, that would be Delita. I think he's made some very crucial plays that have allowed them to win some very big rounds. And then on the Gunrunners side, we had it was Janny, I believe.
Janny, yeah.
Janny on the SMG doing some seriously advanced stuff that has allowed them essentially to stay in the game. That's nothing taken away from any of the players on any team. I think Relax, for me, I think he's a very good AK. I think he just had a bit of a disappointing map there. But as an AK on Crash, I think anyone who's played AK on Crash against a good team knows that it's not necessarily very easy to get some decent frags. And if you're not landing nades, then sometimes it's hard to shut down SMGs at certain points in the map. There's nothing you can do about it, to be honest.
Yeah, and I think also it's a... if you look at the score-wise, well, now you can see the score, but both scopes were... I mean, they were around the middle of the scoreboard for their teams, both Neither and Dex. And I mean, that's a natural outcome when you don't have many scope battles, which we didn't see on this map, at least. Both scopes playing pretty carefully, just trying to grab the mid-round frags.
I think we'll all agree that that's probably a sign of mutual respect for both scopes. I think Neither and Dex are debatably the two best scopes in the game at the moment. Some people may disagree, but certainly opinion I hold, possibly. And I think on a map, in a final like this, maybe you won't want to pick a scope that you know is as sharp as the other one is. And I think it's totally understandable, to be honest.
Yeah, because a scope duel, when you have really high caliber scopes, it will usually just come down to the spawn, basically. So it's safer tactically to go for the mid-round frags, I believe.
Alright, let's see this, if GRS can play as good on attack as I did in the first 12 rounds. Gladi taking a fast approach onto Bialy, through smoke, through a nade onto the B-bomb as well. And again, he's through, and I think nobody hurt him thus far. But there are two players waiting behind the B-bomb for him. Janny takes out Relax, opening up middle. So they have both SMGs on top of hardware. I hope there's no nade waiting for them, because this would be devastating. They find another player in bottom hardware, so taking the 5v3 advantage early on. If they have some smoke execute, Dex can do nothing. But let's watch him. Wow! What a trick there from Neither, landing in bottom scope post. Dex has not seen this coming. Gets taken down by this one. And Samuel G. Pete? What? Where was he? He was lying down in the grass waiting for all of this. Amazing play by him, taking out three players. Again, the individual performance is just huge this game. We love to see this, but yeah, devastating for GRS, who had this whole site under control, I thought. But no, both players actually were on B, one of the red car, and he was just hiding in grass, waiting for the perfect moment, and actually did. So yeah, of course, this slowed things down. They're looking for him right now. Janny, he will make a sound wherever he goes, and okay, decides for the slow ladder approach. Nobody's watching it, so Johnny hears the player in top scopers, and wow, Sam G versus force kill, going for the ace, not gonna get it as Johnny gets the kill. But he's only got 8 seconds to play. He has to find the frag, and he kind of hopes he's somewhere behind the wall, but no, he's not there. He's on the other side, and no luck, no such luck. Johnny just waited for too long, and this was really close. Yeah. Wow, lovely play by Sam.
Here, by the way, guys.
Yeah.
It's yours, Max. Really, by the way, it's Kezo, me, Mac. But yeah, whatever.
Whatever. Samuel G playing really well, first round for Five Kings there. And who should we follow here? Gunrunners have made their way into bottom A. Sko with the bomb. Janny is actually made his way back outside of A, and they're just looking for peaks. CD does find a frag on the leader, and the Zuma goes down as well. It's gonna open up the A side for Gunrunners. They know that they're pushing up on the site. There is a Five King player making his way on Wooden, but he is spotted by Janny. Let's see, they probably planted for spawn here, as Neither is still on the slope. Almost gets taken down there. CD with a frag onto Dex and Sko, with two nice frags there in the end on Relax and Samuel G, and it's a 1-1.
Yeah, I think a very appreciative round there on my side, especially for gun runners. I haven't got a biased opinion towards any team, but I do like to see the underdog at least stick it to the people that are favourites to win anything. I'm going to move on to Janny here because he's moving through mid and he's looking very aggressive. We do have someone from Vikings that's holding mid that hasn't seen him through the smoke, I do believe. Let's see if he can pick them out. He gets tagged from an explosion from a car. It seemed like he heard someone from BLE as well, and he's just poked out, but I didn't see him either. I think Johnny's going to play now a slightly reserved position in hardware, which I think he's very smart to do. I think that Team Gunrunners are looking to find out exactly what Five Kings are looking to do. What Five Kings are doing is sitting in very carefully, playing exactly how you need to play on Crash Defense, but they do have some deleter come around in the background. Fantastic game sense from him. How the hell did he even get there? They are two huge frags from him. Sko eventually takes him down. Janny is looking to protect Sko, who is also having a fantastic game. So I think Sko's played really well so far, showing you exactly what you want to be doing in kind of like final championship games like this. But they're sitting in hardware, and the Team Gunners are in a very, very awkward position here. Dex gets a great deagle frag in onto Janny, and Sko pretty much had nothing to do there. So great round for Five Kings overall. Very respectful tactical gameplay from them.
So as expected, two defensive rounds by Five Kings. You always want to go for the third, but two is an alright score, I guess. I mean, you can't end up on a draw like on a 6-6, as we've seen on the first half. But yeah, Five Kings taking the advantage. So Gunrunners has to do the same for the second overtime, or even go for the 3-0 to take this map. So they're surely gonna talk some stuff through. Mech, make sure you're ready up, as it's only Azuma and Dex to be ready soon.
Yeah, I was just typing in on the chat here. I've just said, what a game so far. I'm called Shawnmeister90 in the chat. I think this has been a fantastic first map. I don't think we could have asked for much more. It's been very tight. I mean, both teams have displayed some good teamwork, and then also there's been some massive individual plays, which I think everyone's totally appreciated. I think the highlight of the entire map was certainly Azuma, who came in with four massive frags. They were totally just SMG spray out and out, because he knew exactly where people were coming from. Got two plus tens, so hats off to him for that. And then I can't
deleter the GRS team. Deleter the first few rounds there when he aced.
That ace was elite. Yeah, that was elite gameplay. Totally agreed there.
Yeah, I mean, it's cool that they're having such a good game. Usually can be a bit quieter and slower and not like freak out that much, because my girlfriend is already actually mad at me because I'm talking so much, I'm talking in a loud voice, I'm so excited. So yeah, this has really been a game-changing game. So really loving this. So, boys.
2-1 as we go into the second half of the overtime. Gunrunners with the first two frags, actually. Relax and Samuel G going down to Neither and CDE. Five Kings a little bit more keen now, not too fast on the A side. And the bomb is down, and it's up to Dex and Azuma now against five Gunrunner players. And quick frags there, and we have a team ace, and it's second round for Gunrunners.
Really good stuff. This is what they need. I thought Five Kings took quite a bit too long to ready up this round, or in the half of the overtime. They definitely talked some stuff too to not make the same mistakes like they did on their attack in the first half, but it didn't work at all. Didn't even get a frag. So let's see how it goes this time. At least I have one frag already. Uzuma with a nade onto Janny, and Gladi peeking out again too much, getting taken out from middle. SamG loving these frags on A when people peek out, so I really need to be aware of this. Uzuma in A with the bomb, deciding to go back out as he was alone, and he kinda hears a player back A and probably suspects a player in A. So let's see what he does. He just chills a bit now. SMG, look at the turret. He's just standing on chopper all round and hopes for peaks. And if you peek, you're just dead. So yeah, CD is doing good and staying in. Neither got naded, so his position is known. Down to 10 HP, but nobody's following up on him, so he can regenerate. Uzuma's waiting for any peek. He does peek. It's a scope versus an SMG duel, and Uzuma getting flashed, but of course no nades anymore, so he has nothing to be scared of. SMG with another frag onto CDE, so A is open, call is coming in, good communication, bomb can be go down. Neil is still stuck kind of on roof, on the glitch roof, because he knows there's a play underneath him, and Sko wants to help him out, but Dex is just smartly moving, as I said, as he's going down to neither, so down to 2v2. Let's see, this Sko has no chance against the turret. He's holding strong this round with the third frag already. And of course he's going for the force. Didn't make a sound on the table, but no reaction by neither whatsoever, and goes down to Uzuma, who was just waiting bottom A. I think he wanted to spray.
I didn't see Uzuma there whatsoever.
Yeah, point of view, point of view.
I'm going to move on to Janny here, because I know I've followed him a few times in the past, but he's had some excellent plays when he's managed to get in on A. He's actually the slower SMG into A here, so maybe not the right person to watch, but it
almost
does look like Five Kings are moving into A quite quickly. There is someone bottom A, he does tag him up. I can't put a finger on who that is. It was Relax, I do believe. Gunrunners are looking to establish a very strong lead on this round. Looks like we're going to go through to a second overtime. Dex with a frag I didn't see, but it probably was quite naughty. We do know Dex is a very good scope. And 3-3. I think this is a really good first map. We might be in for a long couple of games, possibly.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. This is going to be a long one.
I'm really glad we started at 7 PM already and not like at 9 or 10. This would have been horrible. So yeah, maybe we can finish this by midnight. We'll see.
Well, I fucking hope so, because as I said to the two shoutcasters earlier, I have a particular lady coming around later. And
one more viewer for us!
May have another viewer or the only female viewer of this stream behind me sitting on my bed pretty fucking pissed off that I'm doing this. Yeah, we're going to hope that possibly one team gets the win here and takes a 3-0, otherwise I'm pretty fucked and probably not getting laid tonight, boys. So
we're loving the commitment by you just to stick with us no matter how naked she's getting. Call of Duty,
yeah.
Bigger hole. Alright, let's see. Janny has another good spawn into A, but let's the other SMG go first. 4 denades, and he's just following up through blue. They're not taking it too fast, they're just getting their flashes, their nades out to not run into any city rush nades by Five Kings. Janny gets flashed, so one flash less on the A side. He sees a player back A, takes him down with the FPS jump. Good stuff by him. And A is actually open, they didn't have another player following up into A, so they have two players in the garden, but obviously the plant is down already, and Janny just holding middle. Dex is moving in, so is Relax and Uzuma. Sko just holding middle, but they've got four players and everybody is holding middle, so they're just gonna let Five Kings get in. This is a dangerous play, and I don't agree with that. They should fight at least a bit back onto wooden. As Dex got a frag on Nisa, Sko is following up onto him, so at least they get a revenge frags, and as I just said, it's Uzuma. Again, 1v3, but not this time. He doesn't even get a single frag, as CDE did a good job holding the A bomb site from top blue, so good teamwork coming out from GRS.
Absolutely. CDE with three frags that round, and I don't know, it haven't really been a B-favored match so far. Most rounds have gone towards the A site, and as I say that, the bomb is actually gonna rotate towards B long. It seems Glady making his way all the way back in spawn, but Gunrunners actually with the advantage this round. Four players alive versus three for Five Kings. Who is that on the B longs? That's neither. It takes down Relax. That's gonna open up the B side. Uzuma and Dex left to win this round, but Dex goes down, and Uzuma is the last man standing. His backyard with the SMG is gonna be a tough round for him. And the CD is not gonna let it happen. 2-0 in favor of gun owners.
Yeah, silly peek by Relax onto the scope on Bierli, who knew there was a scope waiting for him, but he just was overconfident. But he hasn't been playing circuit to have this confidence. So yeah, in my opinion, silly peek.
I've moved on to Dex now. Go to. He looked like he was looking into blue. He's got a feeling that someone's pushing through mid. Maybe that's through communication. It doesn't appear so. Dex certainly playing a very reserved game right here. He's moving on to sandbags. I believe he's possibly going to go onto mid roof in a minute, seeking out someone within the middle. But Team Gunrunners looking like they're just trying to get a pick here. They do have a player in Bialy who's looking to get a peek onto B bomb. They know that a team like Five Kings certainly have the experience and the discipline when they need to in a game like this for someone to sit on the B bomb and just watch Bialy. Something reminiscent, I remember, in the H2K days where they would have Meissen sit and watch the B-bomb for an entire fucking round on defence. it works out for them. Relax in possibly the most annoying position in the world on low A if you're an SMG, because typically in a game like this, you would not expect it. Maybe a really experienced SMG would walk into bottom A and possibly check there, but I personally wouldn't. So he's sitting very carefully. He does hear someone in front of blue, so he will have called that. And we do have Skos looking towards hardware. He knows someone's there and he gets taken down. It's very much looks like a Five Kings round. And Samuel G, again, he seems to be a player that seems to have very strong rounds and really leads the team in certain rounds for Team Five Kings.
He's just on full turret mode. As soon as he's in a good position where you can peek out players and you show yourself, you're just dead. So Gunrunners have been doing fine pushing him or avoiding him, but as soon you have a silly peek against him, you're most likely dead. So yeah, this can be the difference to not peek in certain situations, especially a defense now. Ready up, guys. And because Gunrunners are walking all around A, like walking up top of the bomb, but down these stairs, on roof, and just Samuel G is just waiting for them for to peek and gets these frags. So maybe staying in, holding it from different angles could be the key, but let's see how they do it. I'm following Johnny as well right now. Escalady, of course, died by a nade, which I knew before. And let's see, he gets flashed, so no control over A as the second nade is coming in as well. So good attacking stuff by Five Kings, who of course need those rounds after losing two rounds on a defense. And Dex with his second kill. Relax and just was just a rollover on A, so lovely nades and of course the push following up on it, so good stuff by them.
Let's see here, it's well, such a close game all along, it's 2-2. Still a first frag there for neither onto Relax. It's gonna make it harder for Five Kings to push the A side. And there is actually no Five King players on the A side so far. Looks like they are favoring the B side. The leader sneaking down on B long. And really quiet so far. CD is gonna jump around the corner and take down Samuel G. And it's a 5 versus 3 in favor of Gunrunners. 5 versus 2. Nice deal from Chani there, all the way from A. CD onto Zuma, and this could be another teammate for Gunrunners. And it is actually CD with the second frag of the round onto the leader. And it's map point for Gunrunners.
First it is time. Map point. It's something I think what we can notice is the deleter is sitting on 1-for-5 at the moment. A guy that's been pretty key to the success of Five Kings within this game. I do, in my personal opinion, think Gunrunners deserve this map. If they were to get this, I think it'd be fantastic for the rest of the game. I think Five Kings, we just see Janny playing a very strong game. He takes down Relax, who has had a slightly disappointing game so far. Do have a lot of respect for Relax as a player on the times I've seen him, but I think this game maybe the nerves have got the better of him. Neither takes a frag onto Dex, and Azuma is left. Now, he's pulled a George Foreman out before. Can he do it again? I think we should move on to Azuma. I think at this point in the game, I just don't believe that he's going to have it in him to do it. I think that GRS are going to play far too smoothly, and they're going to communicate too well for Azuma to pull out another huge, huge round, so I think this is going to be map gunrunners, but let's see if Azuma can move into A and take a frag possibly. They must know he's somewhere nearby, seeing as they can't see him anywhere else across the map. He comes in very carefully, he's lying down, he knows someone's up on roof, so he's going to go for them, and he needs to do it soon. He can't really be pissing about at this point. He takes someone down, and they do have two on roof. I personally wasn't even aware that there were two players sitting on roof there. Fantastic, fantastic map win from Gunrunners. I think everyone's possibly glad that it's going to be 1-0 to them. I think this opens up the second map absolutely perfectly.
I just gave you the AP on TeamSpeak, so we're just going to have a quick peek into the second map. Let's see what they're doing. I just joined and had to ready up because I had a timeout. So it's 11-5.
Is this going to Ace and...
Yes, Ace against Winners. It's 11-5 in favor to Ace, who are on the attacking side right now. So let's see what they're having. I'm just going to shoutcast really quick if you want to follow me back in. We're going to cast this a few rounds.
Yeah.
Winners took down Turtle and Major, following up with two frags onto the Winners in middle. Let's see if there's anything else in it. It's a 3v3 right now, so let's analyze the scoreboard a bit while it's being a bit slower right now. It's pretty even.
You have to take it because the server is full.
Oh, right. I told them to get a higher server, but whatever. Okay. You can tell us when we need to come back, alright?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, cool. So it's down to a 1v3 for MG, who is sitting on bottom frags with 513, so really not performing for his team, which might be a reason they're thus far behind. But as I said, as he gets the first frag in 1v3, but shoots all his bullet out and easily gets pushed by Lowy and dies to 12-5. So we're already on the map point, so this might be over pretty soon.
Yeah, I would imagine so. Once Team Ace, I've been playing with them recently, once they get a grip on the game, very strong players. They've got a very good attitude in the game, great communication. And yeah, Team Winners, once they go behind, are certainly a team that lose confidence in my eyes. Who we will move on to now, we may as well move on to Lowy. He's someone that we've got the Clutch Kings of Team Ace playing right now, so if there are any two players that can win a 2-on-4, this are these guys. But there we go with Divines getting a frag onto Lowy, and I believe he's playing Scope, so we do have Darling, aka Jill, aka the man that everyone wants to be in the COD 4 community at the moment. He's playing on SMG, and Turtle gets two frags, and he gets taken down. So it's a 12-6 for a Team Ace. I think a lot of people were expecting Team Ace to possibly take... Yeah.
I'm sorry, I didn't switch back my screen after I blacked it out for the server connection password. So yeah, RIP, but we'll just see a bit more right now as I just switched back. So let's follow Majo. He's pushing with an SMG through middle, which is a Q position, so... We see Winners holding defensively this round. Three players in A. This is not usual gameplay. Maybe A's have been favoring this bomb site. This decision is being based on something like this. Major is being smoked off on Dockwalk, and there's a player right next to him. He should hear him as he ran into that, but he's just deciding to push through the smoke. Saw a player on the car, kills him, and no, he does not know there's a player next to him and dies to him. Same time, Divine's got two frag and Walking got a frag, so it's only down on Onchi, so it doesn't look like map point just yet. Onchi gets the one frag, only down to a 1v3 now. So yeah, just once more again, I know, because of the delay, you just started hearing all the shortcasts now. Yeah, but we continue.
So I think maybe we're going to Jill right now. If anyone's going to go big for Team Winners and try and bring them back into this map, then it's going to be him. He's surprisingly playing SMG. He typically plays Scope for Team Winners. He's a really irritating player to play against. I think he's a great player. Certainly one of the better players in the community at the moment. Team Ace are looking to move on to the A bomb site. I'm not sure if Goaty disagreed with me there, but I do believe so myself.
For sure.
And it looks like Jill is going to come behind Team Ace. He's going to take someone out of A car park. Yes, he is. He takes Turtle out. That's 12-8. Hopefully, we can see Team Winners come back and bring in a 12-12 here. I personally believe that Team Ace have got the execution and the right work rate within their team to close this map out. But be very interested to see what Team Winners do now. Are they going to bottle the game, or are they going to get themselves back into it?
I'm watching Viking right now. Had the nade frag onto Lowy and the SMG frag onto Unchi, so good stuff holding his team into the game to keep Rex to hold the B sides. As you can see on the minimap, they are slowed down, but Viking going for a silly SMG peek on long range, getting taken out by Turtle. So after playing brilliantly, and now he's kind of losing the round for his team as it's down to Divines in a 1v2. He's also going for a long-range duel with the SMG and getting taken down, and this seems to be GG already.
It must be 2-0 then. I thought this was possibly the first map.
Yeah, but yeah, what's the time, actually? Yeah, it's already been playing 1 hour 20 minutes, so of course we don't have it like on 5 King Sunrunners with several timeouts and double overtime. Of course you can play 2 maps in this time, so yeah.
Very unexpected there, personally. I was expecting that to be first map.
Ace apparently won 2-0.
Oh, okay.
They convincingly won. They were 13-8 up on City Streets. I'm not sure what the first map was, but yeah, looked like a fairly convincing win for them. If you were to look at the scoreboard of Team Winners, everyone was negative fragging, so whatever rounds they were getting in were obviously pretty crucial, possibly very tight.
Right, I did copy the wrong IP once more.
Oh, I'm just going to be right back in 2 minutes, guys.
Sure. So, what's the update on our game, Kizo? What's been happening?
Nothing so far. People still having a break.
Alrighty, so I recommend. Obviously, it's 5 Kings, what do you expect? I recommend everybody from the viewers just to get a quick break as well, as this might take a while. Because I think Uzuma said earlier that he's going for a smoke, and yeah, after losing the first map, he's obviously taking his lovely time to enjoy that because he has to get his head back into the game. So yeah, they're surely gonna talk stuff a bit carefully through right now, because you don't want to end up 2-0 behind on a best of 5, because this would mean you'd need to win all the remaining 3 maps to clutch this game. And this is a psychological advantage right now for GLS winning the first, because I do not think 5 Kings were expecting any troubles like last season. They just wanted to win this 3-0 easy peasy, but nope. Not this year.
Alright, it looks like they are ready to play now though. Everyone just joined up and readied up, so.
So yeah, max AFK, great.
Yeah.
I'ma kick him real quick so we don't delay the game.
No, he's ready.
Sorry, guys,
okay,
I'm
you're back.
I'm back.
Perfect. Perfect timing, mate. Perfect. So yeah, it was just confirmed 13-8 both maps for Ace, so they take the third rank, they get a bit of the prize money, and losers going home without any. Did some drama to get back into the semifinals, they lost it, they played the game for rank 3, and they lost it, so yeah. Big whoop for nothing, they go home without any money. Unlucky for them.
Yeah, unfortunate for Team Winners. I mean, myself and Kessa were unfortunate to lose to those guys in the first round of the pay-to-play finale, so to say. They played a very awkward game, and they did deserve it. So, to be honest, I expected them possibly to come out with some stronger rounds against Gunrunners and Ace, but it just goes to show that there are certain levels on COD 4 at the minute, and team winners or losers, whatever you want to call them, are just slightly below the elite level of the game as it is right now.
Yep.
Well, they had their chances now the last couple of games, and you could possibly also argue that, I mean, all of the things that went down with the semifinals and stuff also drains a little bit of your energy and the focus of the game. So I definitely understand from their point of view, but they got the chances at least, and just didn't work out for them this season. So
no, I'm sure they'll be back next season. I mean, I think
they're very dedicated.
They're very dedicated, and I think certain players didn't show up. I hadn't seen in a big game Darling show up. I mean, I played a few CGs against him recently. He's played very well. And in these particular games against higher caliber players such as myself and you, Kesso, I'm not sure if you'll agree or not, but he hasn't quite shown up. And also players like Walking, I think is a great player. I found it very difficult in the AK battle between us two when we played, and he also didn't seem to come up with the goodies, as they say.
Absolutely, absolutely. All right, we're live here, right? Is it
yep.
Knife?
Yeah, it is knife. While they're knifing, I just want to thank everybody for following, for being active in the chat. Keep this up, guys. And of course, follow Kezo as well. What's your Twitch channel, Kezo?
It's KesoLol.
You can see him in the chat as well, so you can just click on him, go to his channel and follow him. And we are just getting ready with the knife for the knife decision. And it's again Five Kings clutching the knife. And of course, Johnny being a little troll, wanting to dictate what they're starting at. And it looks like Five Kings staying on defense again.
It's something that I'd actually quite like to point out. If we were to look back in the days of teams that were particularly confident, just like Five Kings right now, if this were H2K in their prime, back when Froz was playing with them, and it was Froz, Miracle, etc., they would take attack in a heartbeat because they were so confident about how they could do on the attacking side, and then they could go into the defensive side with some kind of knowing of like where they are on the map. But Five Kings choosing both times to take the more defensive approach, and it seemed to fail last map, as we saw. So it'll be interesting to see if they work better on the defensive side.
Alright, just gonna go ahead and start. Relax took a short break to go into A as he was afraid of the rush nades, which just killed the Zuma, so it seems to be a good timing going in, dodging the fast nades and not getting killed by the late nade. So let's see, he is behind Kav, but I think somebody would see him if he was going to watch from mid-shops. He just repositioned himself to not be open by that again. He hears a player going overlook, so he's probably going to call that, but everybody who knows Gunrunners knows they have a player on overlook the first 20 to 30 seconds every fucking round. So yeah, they are surely aware of that. Relax moved on a bit further to Kav, goes for a weird peek. I mean, he heard a player behind Calf and sprays him like he was in Calf, so not a good play by him. Almost died to it as well, but luckily survives right now. So only 40 seconds to go, and Gunrunners have not a single player in A yet. And CDE just tried to move in alone, died to Relax, but good follow up by his teammates. Go and Johnny are only the last remaining, now only onto Johnny, but yeah, this is a late push coming in, and of course everybody from Five Kings is ready to rotate to A quickly because it did not look like a B play at all. So yeah, easy round for Five Kings.
Really well played by Five Kings there. I just want to say before you continue, I had some someone say before that there was some sort of Skype sound going on the stream, so that whenever you talk, me and Mac gets lowered if we talk at the same time. I don't know if anyone else is experiencing that, but if you feel like that's the case, type in the chat so we can see, because I've only heard it from one so far. But let's jump in the game. It's a 3v3 situation here, and Five Kings, Gunrunners already made their way in and planted a bomb on the A side. And see here, they're actually pretty pinned down there on the A site. Five Kings surrounding the area. Gunrunners just sitting in, playing carefully. CD and Sko with one frag each. It's all up to the leader now. He's in the site. He grabs the frag on CD, jumps around the corner. Oh wow, tags up a player there behind the bin. And does find the Deagle frag. There's one more to go. He's only got 10 seconds on the clock, and the time is gonna run out here. But really nice try there from the leader.
Doesn't even try to go for the defuse. He wanted to frag hunt.
Sko coming up again. I've got more and more respect for Sko going through as the rounds go by. I am going to move on to Deleter here. He's going to be holding an AK or a frag, possibly pushing Garage. No, Yes, he is going to push Garage. 5 is looking to establish a very aggressive approach in this game. They don't respect the fact that Team Gunrun is moving too quickly, but he doesn't see someone coming in. He gets scope, but does not know someone's a statue. Can he get the second frag? No, he can't. Gunrun is soon to take advantage and have pushed into the statue area and are about to get the bomb down. Danny looking up to see if there's any nades coming in, but it is a 3-on-4. Can Team 5 Kings get the frags? Dex comes in with a crucial frag, so this should mean, by all means, that 5 Kings can take this back and defuse the bomb. Neither with a huge frag to Zuma, but Dex taking down Gladio on the bomb. Neither again going huge and open. Are they going to have trouble defusing this bomb with a scope as distinguishes him? Nope, Dex playing absolutely fantastically. This is the Dex that we all know. He can play so strong, and he just secured that round essentially by himself, in my opinion, for his team.
Explosives defused.
Could prove crucial to what the score is at the end of this map.
Yeah, unfortunately for Neither, he thought somebody's already defusing, so he peeked out quite aggressively, exposing himself to both players on statue. If he just sticked in and focused on the one player he saw on statue, he might have had a chance, but yeah, of course, if there are two smokes on a bomb, you obviously expect someone to be defusing if your position on Overlook is known. But yeah, let's move back with Jenny moving into the B shops. He lost his teammate Gladi on the way. It still has two players on his right to find, but his weapon switch probably was heard already, so his position is most likely known. Everybody just holding passive positions of 5 Kings. Look at Samji, again, he's just heard a player, saw a player next to him, and lets him pass, and he's going to go in for the triple kill and gets no, it doesn't get a plus 15, but anyway, nice frags from him there, so really good stuff, amazingly played. So, what can you do, CD, on a 1v5? 1v4, actually. So, let's see.
Samuel appears to be the sneaky player for 5 Kings, doesn't he? He appears out of nowhere. Seems to surprise teams.
In CSGO, he would be the lurker, but he's just doing smart plays and lets people run past him in weird positions and just goes for bee sting in the end. This time didn't work out too good, but it still decided a round, I think. Okay, CDE again in a 1v3. There's three players in front of him. He's stuck in calf, getting spammed. I think there's no way out of this. He gets tagged up again. How more bullets can he take? The answer is one by Azuma and goes down to it.
CDE just tanking 5 Kings. So many bullets. 3-1 in favor of 5 Kings. Deleter on top for his team. No surprise there. He had a bit of a struggle in the overtime last map, but overall, he's played a really good game. Let's see here. I'm going to check the overview map here. See what goes down. Gunrunner's opening up the A side a little bit there. And not too much happening right now, it's really quiet on the map. And nade goes out at least, but everyone is just sitting back, waiting for their opponent to make a mistake. There we go, first frag. After the silence, it's CDE onto the leader. Dex almost goes down as well. Azuma is just crouching behind the site on A, waiting for someone to push in. And they are a little bit spread out here actually, but the bomb is on the street. Samuel G with two frags. And Gladius made his way all up into B house. He's gonna come behind Dex now and takes down Dex. And Samuel G is there with his third frag of the round. But
there's no time.
With the reply, and there's no time to get the bomb down. So this is gonna go for 5 Kings.
Oh. Very close.
I should have looked the other
very
way.
Very close, yeah. That could have been an absolute disaster for 5 Kings. I think I'm gonna watch Samuel G. He is playing a very careful game right here, but it's probably a good for the possibly community to see how very reserved AK, sits there game sense wise, gets out some great frags. I mean, he's done it time and time again within this game, so let's just see how he's playing the B position. So far playing very standardly, he seems to know that no one really has gone to the B side, although he does suspect someone's either at B link or B shops, bid shops, sorry, and he's correct, I'm thinking so. It's coming around in the back when we've got Glady with a big frag onto Deleter, Samuel G onto Naiba, and Yanni onto Azuma. Glady onto Relax, the frags are coming in very quickly, and Team 5 Kings getting dropped like flies there, and GCRS picking up a really important round.
Yeah, good stuff, finally getting back into the game, so this is what they need after losing 4 rounds. Let's follow Jenny this round, who has picked up the bomb and looks like a fast A approach, at least all players are walking towards that, but again a nade frag by Azuma onto neither. Taking down the scope, CDE at least with a revenge frag. A lovely nade from Relax into back half, taking out Johnny. There was no time to react to that. And follows it up with an SMG frag as well. And as I'm speaking, it's already down to 1v4 for Glady, who took out first. But there's still 3 more to find and can't even get the second frag of the round. So yeah, good nades, good executes and good peaks by 5 Kings coming out.
Much faster rounds as well than what we were seeing on Crash, something definitely to note. So I think this map, I don't expect to actually see overtimes in this map. I think that this map's going to end quite quickly, to be honest.
Very confident. Vikings looking more confident this map, and looking more like the 5 Kings we know from the P2P ladder. And let's see, it's usually pretty slow rounds. Not too much happening in the beginning of the rounds, both teams just waiting for a mistake to be made. And Gunrunners again. Making their way towards the A site. Jani with the frag there on the leader, Relax losing HP by the bullet, but does manage to survive. Dex with the frag onto Jani though, it's now a 4 versus 3 situation in favor of 5 Kings, make that a 2 or 4 versus 2 situation now. And Neither and Sko is going to have to come up huge here if they want to win the round. They are inside of A, at least Sko is. Heavily tagged up though, let's see. Not a lot of time on the clock as well, neither with the Deagle frag, but both Sko and neither gets taken down there, and it's 6th round for 5 Kings.
Neither missed some key shots there, so he really needs to step up his game.
Yep.
Is indeed. I think I'm going to move on to Deleter here, just to give him some air time. He's looking to go into the top scope house. It appears as if I've actually got 3 guys possibly towards B, definitely 2 on the flowers area. Deleter seems to know that there's no one pushing in quickly on A. So there's no immediate reaction with the 5 Kings to think there's anything dangerous moving towards A. We do have someone, however, pushing. We've got Sko, who's holding the B shops area, looking if someone's going to be coming from A bins back into the B scope house. And he's got the bomb, so he's very dangerously moving by himself into the B-bomb area. He knows that someone's going to be there, but he's taking the chance, and that's what you've got to do on Strike. You once you establish a certain point of the map and you make yourself a threat at a certain position, then you've got to move in on the bomb site. It's as simple as that. And Sko is doing that, but he's doing it very carefully. He does have Neva sitting next to him. They managed to get the frag on Dex, and it looks like they're going to get the bomb down now, and he's got a smoke, which is huge. I don't really understand why Sko as an AK has a smoke at this point in the round, but he does, which works absolutely perfectly for GRS. And I think he's making the right decision moving into spawn and doing what he's doing right now. but he has also got five skins of Zuma moving around, and it was badly played from him. All he needed to do was aim his angle out and aim it towards the bins, and then just move into a more defensive position where he's able to essentially just control the bomb. But we've got a Zuma coming in, teabagging everyone, and he looks like he's enjoying it. It looks like he's dipping his balls into
I think he teabagged his own teammates as well. Explosives
diffused. Well, we all do like teabagging our own teammates. I won't like that. I teabagged Kesso a few times after I've dropped four mans, and he's died straight away. So,
alright, take a room. Alright, let's follow up with Dex. He's watching the B link push as he gets smoked out. He's not going for predict shots, he's just going for a nade onto the main street. Goes up into scope house. You can see on the minimap it's a straight A go, really quick play. Dex can't see anything though. I'm gonna switch to Gladys. Go with two frags already. And they've got A on lock. They just don't need to die right now. Neither finally stepping up, getting the frag onto Dex and the scope tool from Overlook. And it's only down to SamG, and the turrets had to move. And if a turret moves, he can't kill anything and he dies.
These A pushes look like they're working perfectly for Gunrunners. I don't know why they're trying to switch things up when every round they've won, I believe they've moved towards A.
That was a really fast round, by the way.
Very quick.
Alright, let's see here. Two nade frags for Gunrunners. Looking good so far in the round, and they're moving heavily, just swarming into the A site right now. The bomb is in. Sko is gonna get the bomb down anytime soon. Deleter and Samuel G, let's see, where are they? Where is Deleter? Is in B shops, and we have Samuel G all the way in the back. Gets taken down though by Neither, and Janin with the frag onto the leader. Really quick rounds here, and Gunrunners closing in on the Five Kings lead.
So it's me there, I was just typing in the chat. We do have Janin who's made a really quick push on Link. He's moving towards the garage area and expecting someone possibly from Team Five Kings to be putting him under some sort of pressure, which he's not. He's going to be jumping over the wall here, looking for a revenge fag, and he gets it on Relax. Relax originally got one onto Glady. I don't think Jenny knows that they've got someone sitting on single palms and bin, so I think Team Five Kings are very aware that the Gunrunners team are looking to establish themselves on A, and they look like they're defending pretty well as it becomes a 4-on-3. Dex playing quite conservatively. He's just sitting trying to watch the middle street. I'm presuming that we have Samuel G sitting in B shops. We do. He's had some success there, so understandably he's playing the position where he's feeling very strong. He is going to meet someone at Link right now. He's thrown a nade up in the air that I do not believe is going to connect. If it does, no, it doesn't. He's ready for the duel here, and he wins it. He's successful against Sko. And then we've got Dex who comes onto Neither. Perfect team play and very well defending his teammate.
We're down to 4-8, so yes, it is a defensive base map, but not as heavily as Crash in my opinion. So Five Kings looking really strong, and GRS looked like they only took rounds if they fast pushed and on top of that had some nade frags, because they had like 2 or 3 pushes into A, but without any nade frag. And of course there were plays waiting on statue bins and calf, and they didn't have any chance against them because they've thrown all the nades to the fast push, and if they're not connecting they can't position nade, so they can't make use of the nades to get these bins nade, to get the car for the magic wall nade, which you desperately need if you push into A.
Yeah, I think Gunrunners will be slightly disappointed with the scoreline now. I think they would have taken a 7-5 possibly. I think an 8-4 was, personally, it was deserved from Five Kings. I think they were the better side this map, certainly. But I think right now this has set Five Kings up to very possibly take a really big control on this map, providing they start the attacking side strong. I think that they'll have it. But if Five Kings do get if Gunrunners do get two rounds in, I expect the map to actually to be quite tight. I think this is very much the first, second round. I think it's going to decide how this map goes.
Let's have a look on the scoreboard. It's CDE only on 5 frags. He was, I believe, top fragging last map. So it doesn't seem to be favoring the attack on strike. Maybe he can step up his game on defense. On the other hand, we have Nida, who finally stepped up his scoping game and had some frags in the last few rounds. And on 5 kings, it's pretty average. Relax, again, bottom fragging is every game. And the others are just on equal frags almost. So yeah, it looks like team play coming in. And they were fortunate enough to take a 4-round advantage on defense. So they're feeling confident, I think, but we'll see.
So who are we following, Goaty? Who are you following first round?
Let's take it up with the scope, who's going to be in the first. I see it's Neither jumping onto this DV jump. Just looking into the 3 smoke, so there's nothing you can see. He goes for 1 spray, not for more, because he's scared of any return spray or nades onto the position, and moves back to spawn, watching the calf position really passively. There's a fight going on B. It's Skull being tagged up heavily. Not sure by whom. Neither's helping him out, so let's move back from that. Again, a slow approach, and of course it's going to be Sam G with the first strike. If it's slow, he doesn't have to move, he has time to aim, and then you're just dead if you peek. I'm repeating myself all over again, but Sam G seems to be finding those frags all over the map. And again, it's not been any faster by that frag. Dex is jumping a bit around behind Calf, looking for any peek under the A-bomb. And he actually... did he spot a player there? Is there a player? There is a player, yeah. And he just killed him as I moved away from him. Lovely. And 5 Kings executing now onto A after those 2 frags, and only Johnny remaining gets taken out by Dex as well. His 2 frags for Sam and 2... and 3 for Samuel G this round. So yeah, slow approach, but as soon they got the peek, they got the kills, they're executing. So again, it seems like don't peek against 5 Kings.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not sure if Kesso's here, but I think this is what we expected. I think we expected if 5 Kings establish a lead in this game, then they're going to run away with the map. They didn't do that last game. The Gunrunners come up with some fantastic plays, and they essentially just pulled it out of the bag when they needed to. Gunrunners have actually got the first frag in this round, though. We've got Neither coming onto Azuma, and they look like they've got some pretty strong defensive positions. That's going to make 5 Kings... it's going to make it very difficult for 5 Kings to move in onto the A bomb site. 5 Kings, however, do have someone on the A statue that I believe Gunrunners have no idea is there. So, whoever that is, that would be Delita. He's got the frag, which is a crucial frag. Yanni, the massive frag onto Relax, so he's taking control of the bomb site back. And we had Samuel G, who was on the B area, like he seems to always be, who gets taken down. So, great round there from Gunrunners.
To be fair, in favor of Gunrunners, it usually takes a couple of rounds to adapt to the attacking side's style of play. So usually you see the defending team giving up 1 or 2 rounds before they adapt, but it looks like Gunrunners are fairly confident in knowing what 5 King does after just losing 1 round. It's all up to Azuma now for 5 Kings. He's in mid shops. I'm not sure if Gunrunners are aware of his position. They probably are, because Neither is checking the mid shops. Azuma, he is gonna sneak out onto B shops, but CD is gonna spot him, tags him up, and not looking good for Azuma right now. However, we have said that before, and it worked out the other way around, but Neither takes down Azuma, and it's the 6th round for Gunrunners.
This time it wasn't 4 players running into him on a 2-inch staircase, so unfortunately for him. So another timeout coming in. Not sure what's the reason. Johnny saying thank you because they had bad spawns. Some trolling coming out once more by the Czech player. And look at how quiet 5 Kings are. Usually they're quick on a response on such a comment. They seem to be focused. They don't want to lose any more maps in this game. So yeah, finally they found a way to shut up Dex and his companions.
It's definitely not an easy task.
Yeah, for sure. Many tried, many failed.
No, it's, I think it's nice to see that Five Kings have not necessarily met their match, but they've met a team that can cause them all sorts of problems. And I think at this stage of COD 4, there are very few teams that appear to be on an elite level. And we all know that both these teams here are very much on an elite level. So it was great to see the slight underdog in this matchup take the first match. Five Kings appear to have control at the moment. Whether this timeout necessarily was tactical or whether someone just needed a piss or whatever, they've taken the timeout. Whether it disrupts the flow of the game for either side is also going to be very interesting. Hopefully on my side, I think Gunrunners come in and make it a bit of a closer map, take a few more rounds. But I think if Five Kings get the next round and the round after, then I think it's going to be a map to Five Kings fairly quickly. And I think we're just going to have to look forward to the map after that.
But it was a quick timeout once more coming in after only losing two rounds in a row. So I'm really not sure what's the plan here. If Uzuma is going to ask Gunrunners for a timeout again, as he did on Crash, and then being mad if they don't do so. There's no reason to do it. I mean, if they use it that early and then they have a problem later on, I'm not sure the decision is right to take it with a 9-6 lead after losing two rounds. Of course, you want to stop the momentum and get those this tense round and a mental advantage, but in my opinion, it's a bit too early. What do you think, guys?
I'm personally under the impression that this is a final, and any of the timeouts that are being taken are used to discuss possible things that I need to quickly go through before. I don't think Five Kings want to give the Gunrunners team a chance to get back in the game. And if I were in their position, I would totally take the time out and say, let's discuss what we're doing, who the fuck's causing the problems, and what are we going to do to counteract what they're doing, basically.
Well, to Relax or else. Relax taking the blame.
Yeah, well, Relax had a really bad, he had a bad game last game. I think it'd be unfair to say it's particularly this game that he's been the problem, really. I think he's level fragging enough and is more down to a case of team play. We've seen him play well in previous games. I think that the rounds that have gone wrong have just been Gunrunners using their experience and communication skills to kind of get them through it. But I think we'll see by the end of the map possibly who's been the weak links on either team. Oh, so is this me now coming into
yeah.
this?
You asked so, for it. Go for it.
I'm gonna watch Glady. He's thrown a nade over a fast nade that hasn't connected onto anyone, and then he gets taken down by Dex, who throws like one of the most annoying nades on Strike Attack ever. But we are following Yanni, who gets two absolute drags, gets taken down, and Relax ends up taking down Sko. So we're on a 2-on-1 here, Five Kings. Essentially, just Steve rolled that round. It was such a fast round, it's very hard to keep up with. And this is the sort of pace that we expect Five Kings to go with quite a lot of the time. It looks like they've got a lot of confidence. I said in the last round, if they continue this, then they'll steamroll the map. Five Kings win this round, I believe that that's theirs, but let's see what Gunrunners can do.
Yeah, I'm going to take it up with Johnny because he had a lovely spawn. It's already at Magic Wall, so no early aggression from Five Kings this round. But Dex just gone into mid-shops and had a lovely timing as he was, CD was just moving from Taps to Calf. And Gladdy following up on Dex, but Relax finally with a good track. And leaving Sko and Neither in a 2v4, they lost control over A, so this is looking desperate once more. Sam G is in turret position. So there's nothing they can do. Relax dying to his default nade, that's kind of embarrassing. He should have heard Neither jump on the A pin as well as looking in the sky seeing the nade, but yeah, this can happen under the stress level he has to be in a final like this. There is money on the line. Let's see what's happening. The leader's finally going for the plant and Samji is still hiding. Will he have the timing on the garage player? He's still not looking up. If he's going to peek too late, there will be a player in arrow. And yep, he is definitely too late right now. So let's see if this will have a disadvantage in the end. neither taking out the laser, but of course not checking his back. So Sam with a follow-up frags go in A now. Hearing the leader closing in, wanted to avoid him real quick, but he was stuck in a position and gets taken out. So another good round by Five Kings, taking it to 11-6.
Yeah, looking really good for Five Kings right now. Samuel G definitely stepped his game up a little bit. 18-11 frags. 18 frags, 11 deaths. So let's go ahead and follow him. He is actually playing AK, so might take a while before we see any action from him, but he has made his way towards Cafe, so let's go ahead and switch over to Uzuma, who is already inside the B bomb with the bomb there, but neither with his third frag of the round there. Just sneaking behind the Five King players. And see, Dex is outside. He actually spot neither there, but misses the shot. That was unfortunate for Five Kings. Neither basically single-handedly just shot down the B push there. It's going to be tough for Five Kings to recover from this. Samuel G has made his way into statue area, just trying to clear out the A site. He has a player just proning on the A bomb. And I don't believe he's going to peek Samuel G, so he's going to basically have to walk up to him. And let's see how Dex responds to the info that Samuel G is giving him, but he goes down actually to Glady. It's all up to Dex. The bomb is locked down on the B side, it's not going to happen. Neither grabs his fourth frag of the round. Excellent play by Neither. I don't really know how he got to the position that he was at, but great play from him, just stealthing behind the Viking players and winning the round for his team.
I want to point out that he did 4 kills and none of them was a scope.
Yeah.
He naded one, deagled one, picked up SMG and killed the last two with it. So
That's reminiscent of old scopes though, where the scopes actually are very good at using their deagles. You don't necessarily have to rely on your scope the whole time to be a good scope. It's all about game sense skills with your deagle, and as everyone knows, a deagle can beat an AK up at close range. So players in the past like Robbie and Stevie were often very good with deagles, and there's no problem with that, providing you're playing the game right and you're not wasting your range of the scope. We do have Yanni with a relax there, and then Lady and Yanni both connecting onto Dex and Statue. And pick up runners there, but it seemed to happen all so quickly.
The round started slow but ended in real fashion in the end, with 4 frags in like 10 seconds or something like that. So yeah, sure, it's looking strong on defense, but they just need to keep it that way. They can't win a round, lose a round, win 2, lose 1. They're gonna end up losing the map if it's continued like this. And again, Five Kings are in A, and I can't even talk that fast. Go is on a 1v4 and they're just losing the round. They couldn't get into A, no lockdown, and just an easy fast push by Five Kings going down with 4 map points right now.
It's super hard to keep up with. I've noticed like the last couple of games that I've streamed as well, the rounds usually like it's usually slow in the beginning, but once the rounds start, basically the first frag comes in, it's just like revenge frag, and then the round is over. So really quick rounds nowadays, but
to cast we might add as well from our part of the team
indeed, but this round isn't so fast actually. Janny did go down to he actually got tagged up by 2 nades there and died on the second by Relax. Five Kings gonna play it slow. They're just gonna pick out the Gunrunner players defending the A side, it seems. However, Gunrunners have good info on Five Kings' positioning so far. Neither with 2 frags there. Nade frag and an AK frag. Relax revenge frag onto Neither though. It's 2v2 now. CD and Sko versus Deleter and Relax. The bomb is on the A site. Relax is checking for any nades coming in. He gets tagged up by on the street though. Survives.
Deleter of the elite game sense.
Yeah. Well played by Deleter, and it's all up to CD. He's tagged us. So actually switches up, and yeah. I don't know what happened there, but the round goes to five kings, and it's 1-to-1 in maps, basically.
In the maps, they totally and utterly deserve this map. I don't think anyone could deny that. The last round totally just showed how five kings as a singular performance, aka from Deleter there, used his game sense to win the 2-on-2 quite easily, although he did nearly fuck up quite badly at the end. I think this has opened up the final spectacularly, to be honest. Do we know what the next map is from here?
It is City Streets, as it is said, as they banned Backlot and Crossfire.
Okay. I think City's a very good map to go for a 2-1. And then, yeah, Backlot and Crossfire.
Yeah, we will see definitely one of the both. It's quite cool. But yeah, this could be easily a 5-map game.
It appears so. I mean, I think it appears to be about who's going to show up. I mean, we've got some players that have shown up in each map so far. I think Deleter has debatably been the strongest player, possibly, across both maps. But then we've had people like Samuel G. He turned up on the second map and got some crucial kills. Azuma, there's someone who had obviously a big round, and he's had a couple of rounds where he's got some decent kills. I think every player here has contributed quite well. I think I personally would like to see a little bit more out of Relax. I think he needs to go by his name and maybe relax a bit more, and he might be able to contribute with his team a little bit better, and kind of showcase the skills that he's got more than he has done so far. But again, on COD 4, it's not always easy to showcase your skills as an AK. Sometimes what you do as an AK is overshadowed by the work by the scope and SMGs. So let's just see if he can pick it up in this game, which on City Streets as an AK you certainly can if you play it correctly.
I mean, best of five is a pretty unusual format to play. It's 1-to-1 now in maps. How does it like, how many maps more can we expect if let's say they just continue to draw it? Can you explain, because I'm a little bit lost since the match format is a little bit different.
Well, the first wins three maps wins the game, so at least two maps going to come up, and if each team wins one, we're going to the fifth map, which will be the last map.
Yeah, indeed. And yeah. In terms of picking the map, what you said earlier, was it
each team vetoed the map, each team picked the map, so they played their picks, then they played the leftover map, and if it's not decided by then, they knife for the maps they vetoed earlier, which one is going to be played first.
Oh, okay.
Apparently they changed up to loser's pick. This is like arguable. Some people say knife for it again, some people say loser's pick, so yeah.
No, I agree. I think loser's pick is actually fair. Makes it to be especially in the final much more exciting, so the team that loses the map and goes behind 2-1 gets a chance to play on a map that's favourable to them, and then, debatably, could be either a very strong map for them or maybe a close map if we're looking at on an underdog basis. So,
how are we looking on side advantage on City Streets? Do you think any side is more favourable here?
I'm going to step in and say with these two teams, I don't believe so. I think if maybe like a team like Gunrunners, they're the type of team that are going to sit in and play very conservatively and kind of be really keen and possibly piss off 5 Kings if they do it right. 5 Kings are much more aggressive than a team that are going to try and get in the face of any team they go against, regardless of what side they're on. So I don't know, it really depends. But for me, I don't think there's necessarily much of an advantage on sides with this map. I think it's more about mentality and team play more than anything else.
Kizo, your opinion?
I don't know. It's gonna be. It's hard. I mean, like I was pretty confident. I mean, I know Gunrunners is a very experienced team. They can come in with I mean, they can surprise anyone, but I think most people thought Five Kings would grab both of the first maps here, so I'm not really sure what's gonna happen on this map, to be honest. I mean, if Gunrunners played like they did on Crash, or if Five Kings make as many mistakes as they did on Crash, I believe this this map could go either way as well. I don't know, it's really hard to tell.
But you're just waiting for Five Kings player once more, as they seem to be again focusing more on this map, talking through stats.
To be fair though, I should say, not to call out Five Kings on the Crash side there, both teams made a lot of mistakes. Like, especially the round there when Uzuma clutched around and deleted their ace, and you know, there was like back and forth mistakes from both teams, which I think was what made the map so close. And it felt like at least Five Kings tightened up a little bit on strike. They didn't make as many mistakes, played with more confidence. And I mean, if they continue like that with this map, then it's going to be about the same score, 13-7 or 13-8 or something like that.
Yeah, what I like to point out on City Streets is in my opinion, team-based maps. If you're playing it mixed, it's kind of hard. So GRS has been together for years, and Five Kings are kind of a mix of random players that play together in a few combinations, of course. But if the executes are perfect from GRS, I'm wondering if Five Kings can react to that.
Yeah, that's very true.
I think what it is you're looking at a team of kind of mediocre experience together with raw talent against a team with just complete experience and faith between each other. So it's a very interesting contrast between both teams here, and that was something I wanted to bring up before the match that I think I have and haven't to a certain degree, but it's something that I think will show across the next two maps that we're about to see here.
Let's go live with a knife again. Let's see if any team is keen to take it once more. Five Kings already took the first two, or I think even three knives. They won the map decision, they won both side knives. So yeah, they're looking to have the longer blades, and they're going for the around the world strat, famously known from back in the day. And seems to be working out at least a bit, as it's down to a 1v1 between Relax and Sko, and Relax finally stepping up for his team with two knife frags at least. If he doesn't frag in-game, at least he gets some knife kills, so yeah, he's still useful. And again, Five Kings starting on defense. Third time they've done this now, so yeah, they're feeling confident. Mac, do you take it?
Am I going to take someone now? I'm actually going to go on to Yanni first. He's got a good spawn with SMG. He's opted not to use his good spawn, actually. He's throwing a nade into mid-market, which I'd hoped he didn't do. But he's got good smoke. He's looking to jump down. And he's going to move towards the B-doors area. He expects someone to be holding mid-market, which they aren't. But he does get tagged from someone at the A-arch side. So the round looks like it's very much slowed down from both teams. No one wants to give away the first frag. Something's going to happen here by A-Arch, and Relax is going to take down Glady. Glady possibly should have slowed down there. Nothing was happening. And it appears that Gunrunners are looking to take control of the A-bomb site, with Yanni playing a, in my eyes, pretty clever play in the middle of the park, where it doesn't appear that Five Kings are trying to establish any control of. But he does get tagged from someone sitting in spawn. I always hate anyone that sits there, and it's Dex. Dex sitting in the most annoying position, I think, on the map for City Streets. And I think Five Kings are very aware that the Gunrunners team are looking to get the bomb down on A. I think Gunrunners are in trouble here. Five Kings are getting some frags onto Gunrunners, and we've just got Sko sitting by himself in A arch. Got Five Kings that are looking everywhere to try and find out where he is. I think this is definitely going to be a Five Kings round. Sko does manage to take Dex down though, and he does manage also to take down Relax. This is a one-on-one situation. He's going to get the bomb. He has to try and plant or he's fucked. Although he is going to try and peek mid-market, and he should have been aiming there. And that was his own problem. I think that was a really bad play from Sko. Like, it was a great play to begin with, but if you're going to commit after not planting the bomb, then you should be aiming with your AK. As simple as that, really.
I totally agree. Wrong decision making. You should have either pushed the market or really aimed at it or just gone for the plant. I mean, yeah, three decisions. He took the force, which was bad. So, yeah, unfortunately, it could have been a great clutch from him, but no, not gonna happen. Five Kings takes the first round and again looks strong in the second. Both scopes got his kill each, but the leader with advantage track onto Jenny with a push nade onto Viali, as we've seen, neither evening up the teammates. So, looks like another B approach from GS, but didn't decide just yet where to go. Relax is in a good spot to hold off any A or mid aggression. What does GS seems to rotate back to A, so let's see how long it takes Relax to hear. So he just heard a player, so he should be calling in. Yeah, the leader's already moving away from B, so they've got all the information they need. Just need to be quick. Let's see. Yeah, Relax gets the first, gets the second, and not the third, unfortunately, but good stuff by him, waiting patiently for them to peek. CDE with a fake, 1v2, and again, only with a fake, and what can he do now? No way, yes, he just needs to walk up in the right moment. Okay, gets the frag on the leader, he wasn't paying attention to the arch, and now he's moving to B.
Big round hit. Azuma didn't see, can we just take note, as if none of the Five Kings team saw. I saw CDE run towards the B-bomb site, none of them saw it, and he's gone back to A. So I have no idea what the fuck's going on here. Communication's terrible and the eyesight's terrible.
Yeah, CDE finally going down for the plant and running away, taking the risk that Uzuma is not in the A building and holding the A arch from a weird angle, but he's not, he has no idea where he comes from, so he has to watch three or four angles and he stays in the open. But the smoke is giving away at least a bit of positioning. So he's still watching the A arch. He does not know he's already out and he's still watching it. He's not afraid of any other position, so, but he has to stay down, I guess. But oh, this was just terrible decision making once more. They're losing the clutches because of wrong positioning after the plant. Don't get this at all. Explosives diffused.
Yeah, I think in rounds like that you need to go back to basics and play very standardly. I don't understand why he didn't use the advantage of hiding behind the wall in a car park.
But indeed,
something that GRS have paid for. I think this is your round, Kesso, here.
Yeah, it is. Yep. Yeah, definitely gun owners need to tighten up on those 1v1 situations, and just in general, don't let Five Kings grab the clutch rounds, because in the end those rounds are gonna be the one that counts. Let's see here, Five Kings shutting down the gun runners A push here. It seems like Dex with two frags, CD though jumping onto the glitch, I believe he was on the glitch, killing Dex with the AK, and Five Kings just trying to recover on the A side. Azuma is going to meet up with a player here anytime soon. He misses the hipfire, pulls up the deagle and kills CD. Fortunate for Azuma, almost gets taken down there, and the fake went down on the A side. But what is happening here? Neither... They did a fake, didn't they?
I don't think so, no.
Oh, I thought I heard a fake. Neither with the bomb though, it just dropped down, so... There's the fake. Two Five King players in the A alley, and it's gonna be really tough for Gunrunners to get a bomb plant down here. See, the leader's gonna peek around the corner, and there, neither's right there on the corner. With Samuel G with one frag, and Azuma with another onto neither, and it's the third round for Five Kings. It's just so hard for Gunrunners to push in on the A side.
Is it you, Mac?
I think it is me. I'm going to go on to Glady. Glady hasn't done so much so far. I want to see if he can establish himself in the game. He's on 0 for 3. He's on SMG. It can be very difficult on city streets at certain points for any SMG. If you haven't got the right smokes, the right nades that are supporting you, and then you've got people that are holding the right angles, and yeah, it's very difficult. But Glady is in a great position here. He looks like he can cause some damage if he plays it right. But Five Kings look like they've really got the A-bomb cemented, to say the least. They look like they're in strong positions. And, oh, Glady really should have landed there. That's very disappointing from him. I think Relax was actually very lucky to manage to get that that shot, and Dex with a great shot there onto Nida. I think they're expecting the last person to possibly be a car park, but he's not. Sko is actually sitting actually in A arch. I'll take that back. I think he's in trouble. I can't see Sko taking anything out of this round. He's about to get dropped now from A arch. Playing very calmly, I will give it to him. But yeah, a deserved Five Kings round. I think GCRS are playing it. GRS are playing it all wrong here, to be honest.
Yeah, I don't know. They tried to go A like three times in a row. Okay, we gotta give it to them. They've gotten into two clutches and almost won these rounds. Just lost them by wrong decision making. But yeah, as soon as they go B, you see what happens. They get this. They get destroyed by Dex and the nades by his teammates. So yeah, it's like down to Glady again with zero frags, and it doesn't look good that he gets his fifth. Nope. Dex with 3 frags this round and easy hold off the B push, and I don't think GRS are going anywhere near the B side anytime soon.
It's surprising though, because it seems like they're not going anywhere near the A side as well. So they're gonna have to try something in the middle. Let's see the scoreboard here. Dex going huge for Five Kings, 10-3 right now. Definitely his map. Make that 11-3 with a nade frag onto Janny and a tag as well. onto, I believe that was CDE, he has like 1 HP left. Glady with double frag there on A, that's really what's going on
in that
round. Yeah, indeed. They seem. Let's see here, but 2 SMGs here on the well in the middle. And the bomb is probably gonna go down. No, never mind. Neither faking the bomb and Dex with the naked frag there. Did Dex just shoot through the smoke there or?
No. Was an open kill.
Oh, it was okay, yeah.
Dex has certainly never shot anyone through the smoke, we all know that.
2v2 right now. They're just trading frags right now, the teams. CD and Neither versus Azuma and Deleter, and Neither is just faking and faking and faking on the A bomb. Just trying to make the Five King players give away their positioning. Deleter is the last man standing now though, and they are pretty aware of where he is. He's just gonna jump down, he's gonna have a player right in front of him on the other side of the well. But yeah, this is gonna be a tough one. 30 seconds on the clock. Gets tagged up, and there we go, CD finishing the round. That's the first round for Gunrunners.
Finally. Yeah.
Thankfully. So, Five Kings calling in another
Seriously.
Timeout. I don't believe that Gunrunners have called a timeout so far, but Five Kings have been calling them every once in a while when they want to discuss things.
Every half.
They certainly don't want Team Gunrunners to get in any sort of momentum. I don't see a problem with this if I was in Five King's position. If we're fighting it up and we get around where we get, I wouldn't say necessarily quite clearly beat, but we've got the momentum. All that the round we can do for Gunrunners is provide them some confidence. So what they're going to do now is possibly just sit in and discuss exactly what they're going to do to counteract anything that's going wrong on their side. And if they can get the next round in, then it's just going to drop the morale of Team Gunrunners, and they're going to be able to sail through and win the map as they do the strike. So, totally understandable timeout from Five Kings. I think on the next round, I'd quite like to spectate CDE.
I would spectate Johnny if he goes for the bond or not.
Oh, that's a very good point. See, Johnny is an absolutely fantastic player. The fact he's 0-0 for 6 is probably the reason that Five Kings are ahead 5-1 right now. So I'll totally agree with you there. Let's spectate Johnny if he actually bonds. I think he's going to be pretty devastated. I think he's going to be shocking for his morale and his confidence going further into the rest of this map, definitely. So yeah, we'll be watching Johnny. I hope for his sake that he picks up his game and starts bringing his team back into it.
Taking the time, only 2 minutes or 5 past, but I think they're getting ready. So Keizo, up yours for ready up, and then we can get this started. Or maybe Gunrunners think, okay, if they're gonna take a timeout, you can talk things through. Nope, we're going live, so Mac, let's see if you can do Shoutcaster's Curse on Janny.
Okay, let's go for it. Right, so we've got Janny, not quite the spawn that he's gonna be wanting, so he's also got an AK, so Team Gunrunners are also switching up guns here. They're gonna try and avoid any of the kind of late nades coming in from A. I say that and you give me the Shoutcaster's Curse, they take a fucking plus 10. Turret G, aka Samuel G, just coming in shitting all over the faces of Team Gunrunners, and it's all down to Sko here. Sko's in all sorts of trouble in a really shit position, and Dex just comes in with the SMG and they walk all over them.
Can we get some Hey James in the chat for Janny? Alright, poor Janny. Let's watch Dex's round. He's got some good frag bases, so maybe he's doing something right. For now, he's just spamming the middle. I don't even think he spams for frags, but just to prevent any mid pushes. So it's more than a tactical spam than a frag hunting spam. So good decision making by him. They got two players on back A, one nade, and it could be easy plus 10, but. There's this scope tool, neither against Dex. Dex actually tagged them up through the thick wall that only like for 10 or 20 damage. So nothing too bad. Relax with two good frags holding down the A side for his team. It's only Dex on the A side. Gunrunners need to move in fast and take Dex out, and Janny does just that. He's said after the bond, okay, I'm gonna start frag right now. I'm gonna carry my team for the win. I hope at least he's doing it. He's predicting a play on top, and is he right? He was right. Samuel G was on top, but neither nades him down, so good communication by Janny coming out. Just got his third frag of the round as well, so it's down to Zuma on 1v3. He is on flowers already. So his position is still unknown, as he didn't fire any bullets yet and massively fails the deagle on long range, unfortunately for him. And now he's an SMG, he got three players to find, sees the first, tags him up, but gets taken down by Sko. So good round by Janny finally showing up for his team.
Huge game sense round. Huge game sense round from him there. Who are you looking to follow, Casso, here?
I'm feeling like we should follow CDE here. He is making his way towards the B side pretty quickly here. There's actually one more player ahead of him on the B stair. CDE's probably going to get taken down now from B shops. He does get taken down, but it's the leader from the fence that takes him down. Janny is with the SMGs out on the stairs. Ooh, almost gets taken down by the barrel there. And the Glady is out with the bomb as well. Let's see what... It's a 4 versus 3 right now. Where are the other... Let's see here. Glady is making his way back towards the A side, but Dix is, has put himself in the... attacking spawn area almost, and takes down Glady as he tries to rotate. No, actually that was Relax who took down Glady, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah, I mean, I think we've got Dex very much in the driving seat right now. I actually do want to speak, I want to spectate neither. I want to see what he's going to try and do to negate what Dex is doing, because he's getting outscoped here. Dex is controlling the game, and he needs to do something for his team to provide them with some opening frags, or just some frags that are going to allow them to push a bomb site. And one thing I will point out is that Gunrunners are looking to establish a strong position on the A bomb site continually, and they are failing. So I'm not sure why they're continuously trying to take this advantage when it's just never happening, quite simply. And Janny has someone that's actually sitting in gay corner on the right here that he doesn't realise, and that's Relax, and he gets taken down by Relax. And we've got Delito, who is in okay form with this game. He's just got a few tags onto Sko, and Sko's playing a very defensive game. He's going to try and kill him in gay corner, but I think he's going to fail. He can't quite see him. He gets tagged through the window and then gets dropped down, and it's 2-8. Gunrunners in a very, very bad position here in terms of winning this map.
For sure, it seems like they're taking the advantage early on, like on strike, and we've seen how this is gonna end, so I kinda doubt Gunrunners have as strong as a defense as Five Kings have right now, and I don't know, they're just attacking A so often and losing it, so I don't know why they're not confident in their B play again. We have only Johnny on catwalk, everybody else is towards middle and A. So they're really favoring the A side, and of course look at the minimap, Five King knows it by now. Okay, they lost two players already, but even after losing two players, I get another two joining in. Dex opening up, let's follow him. He got the first frag. Oh, the team kill coming from Gladi onto Johnny, that's terrible. That can't happen as Dex takes another out, it's down to 2v2. But both players from Five Kings are not by A. Oh, Plant could come in, but neither again for the fake. Of course you can't know, you'd want to wait for your backup to plant, but a wrong decision at the wrong time, just once more. Go. Spotted a player and back flowers who actually doesn't go for the peak, and again with a fake he could plant it by now, and now the smoke is gone, so he's open.
Yeah.
The Arch player is going to push in and just takes him out easily. So Sko in a 1v1 against Zuma. Zuma taking a risk, leaving his position.
He should run to B right now. He's not doing it.
20 seconds. But and he, again, he's faking, he's not going real, yes, and he will have time troubles once more, and the Zuma knows this, and he can go for the peak now. Let's go again, not going for the plant. What are these plays? Why is he trying to outthink a player like Zuma who's been playing the game for 8 or 9 years? It's not gonna happen, mate.
Oh, it's going all wrong for Team Gunrunners here, it really, really is. Is this my round here, is it, coming in?
Yeah.
So I think we should. I want to watch Dex. Dex is the person. He's just got a frag.
Oh.
Taken down. Shoutcaster's curse. But he does take Janny down in the meantime. Azuma gets a frag in onto Nidor. So Five Kings are in a 4-on-3. Looking stronger and stronger as the map goes on. I think that Gunrunners are totally losing their confidence essentially. And that's not something we want to see in this final. They played a fantastic first map. They look very strong, but Five Kings are showing their dominance as they show against so many teams time and time again, and proving the point that they essentially are the best team at COD 4 at the minute. I think what we're all going to hope to see is that Gunrunner's next map are going to give Five Kings a bit more of a run for their money. I think Goaty did say earlier that they're very strong on Crossfire, so I'm going to hope that Crossfire is the next map.
Well, it might be, yeah, it might be their best map, but it's still Crossfire against Dex, so yeah, you can be as good as you want on Crossfire, but if you're going up against a Skull Giant as Dex, you might just not want to pick it.
And speaking about Dex, just look at the scoreboard right now. He's just, I mean, if it wasn't for Dex, Five Kings would be nowhere near the round advantage that they have right now.
Also, a big shout out to Relax, though, who's picked up his game. He's on 14-6, and as I said, I've got a lot of respect for him as a player. I think the way he plays as like very decently, and I think he's just had a shit start to the game. He's come in, he's worked well with Dex now, and he's been very much part of the 10-2.
Oh, watch Johnny, he's in a perfect position right now, but oh, unfortunately I just was ready to cast a plus 20, but he gets taken out by the leader after the first frag, so good reaction by him. But again, it's JRS's favor, getting 3 quick frags and only losing Johnny in the process, so SamG and Relax on the hunt for frags. Relax almost dies to the B player. Meanwhile, SamG opened up the A bomb, and there's nobody left on A. It seems like Five Kings know that, so look at Sko. He doesn't read this at all. He just stays on the B bomb while his team is rotating to A, and he's going to be way too late. So he's still on B. Is there no calls are coming in? Wow. Alright. So yeah, Gladi is in the back at least, so he's got a good position to clutch this first team. So pretty sure Sko's gonna die soon because he makes way too much noise.
Wow, Gladi completely missing.
Oh, Gladi, what are you doing?
Sko should have gone to spec savers quite clearly.
Okay, Sko at least picked something up from his terrible play, so good for him. But goes again with a sneak onto the A-bomb, and now SamG is going to show you how you play a 1v1. Or does he? Or does he? Or does he?
Oh!
Yes, he does. I told you.
There was me thinking Samuel G was finger blasting himself at A-Arch, but he wasn't. He was truly and utterly ready.
Wow, that was close.
0.01 seconds as Yanni's quoting. God, what a close round.
Very close. I'm gonna go ahead and follow Yanni here. I want to see again because he had a good run. Yeah, of course. he had a very good run last round. But the Castlekers, he gets taken out by Nate, of course. Let's see here, just four players, three players alive for Five Kings, two players alive for Five Kings. And let's see, a couple of reply frags here, and all of a sudden it's a 2v2 situation. There's one defender for each site, I believe. And CD has made his way into the attacking spawn almost. Let's see, with Five Kings with the bomb on B site though, Skull gets taken down. CD is gonna have to hurry up.
Explosives planted.
CD is coming in from behind. They are probably well aware that CD is coming from behind. I believe it was Deleter who was already in the B shops. Let's see, they're probably gonna meet up soon. Actually, finds a frag onto Relax. CD does not realize he could be behind him somewhere. Now he does. Oh, he actually saw him by the door there, spots him in, gets the frag.
What a play.
And nice play from CD. That was really, really important for Gunrunners. I mean, every round now is important to not let Five Kings get the map points.
And again, Jesus Christ, Five Kings.
It seems like Gunrunners get a fucking round win, and Five Kings immediately want to shut that down. And I don't know if they're just trying to slow the momentum down, or even if they're discussing it, but maybe they're just trying to just slow the confidence of the team Gunrunners.
Looks like they're saying Sam is not feeling well and taking these timeouts, but it looks like he's not feeling well as soon they lose a round. So.
Yeah. But yeah, I was gonna say earlier, like, I don't really think you can blame a player for bottom fragging in a match like this, because I think it's all about positioning, really. If you're in a vulnerable position, like maybe Relax and let's say Yanni is this map. Yanni is playing the B side SMG. He has to be aggressive. It's a hard position to play. Some rounds you get taken down, some rounds you don't. I mean, it's just a natural outcome of a game like this, that some map, your side, you're just fucked. You can't do anything. You will bottom frag whatever you try to do.
You're totally right. The reason why you're so right as well is if your SMGs, which on the Gunrunners side, aren't doing fucking anything on this map so far, what do you expect your AK can do when one, he's got worried about the AK and the scope on certain areas of the map, and then also SMGs pushing round at any part of the map as well? It's very difficult as an AK to get any sort of frags when, from my position, I don't think the Gunrunners' SMGs are doing enough to kind of open up the rounds. And that also counts for Neither as well. He doesn't seem to have taken control at any point against Dex, who, like, has quite obviously controlled the entire map so far.
But that's the thing here. I think if you compare this map so far with Crash, in Crash, both scopes were showing a lot of respect for each other. As we said, they weren't really going for the fast peaks and stuff like that. They were playing, you know, respectfully against each other. But it feels like Dex has just completely thrown that out of the window right now. Dex is playing, he's super fast to peaks, and he has gained a lot of confidence, I feel like. And Neither is just playing too far back to really do anything. And I also think that Neither is more of a mid-round fragger than Dex is. Dex is a really good entry fragger, and this City Streets is a really hard map to just go for mid-round peaks, because there is so much cover and it's so easy to move close to each other. So I think Dex playstyle is definitely paying off for Five Kings this map.
It's just something I said earlier. I'm not sure if Goaty wanted to mention anything there, but I said that it would take the scopes possibly a little while to kind of gain their own momentum in the game. I said they'd have a slow start, because scopes often do, but once they suss out what the other team are doing, the better scope will prevail, essentially.
Yeah, in the end, it's always going to be like this. You might get a few lucky frags, but if the better scope is showing up, you're going to get absolutely destroyed by him. Let's look, Johnny is good. Looks like a good defensive strat. Yeah, Gladi pushing and him pushing both through the market, but unfortunately, it's only resulted in two frags by Gladi, neither evening up into 2v2. So I would say advantage for Five Kings because they know where one of these players is. But as I just said, the CDE shoots Dex into 1v2, and if you want to have anybody in a clutch, you want it to be Dex, and he gets a sick frag onto Neither. 3 bullets straight into the body of Neither, who was jumping towards the Mazzarini stairs. Smokes up the B side, hopes for any movement of CDE, but doesn't hear anything. And he's going slowly towards the B bomb as he has no idea where CDE is, and he's actually in his back. Will he expect that? Right now he isn't, but he's moving back at the right moment. If he peeks this, this is going to be terrible. Unfortunately for CD and Dex, once more, 4 frags in this round, carrying his team to victory. And we've got 9 map rounds for Five Kings right now.
Absolutely, and Dex just adding even more frags to his already big lead. Sko is the top fragger for Gunrunners, not looking too confident though. He's the only one who has positive score for Gunrunners. Wow, just looking at the leader here, and from Double Doors, grabbing a nice Deagle frag, one SMG frag, and almost grabs the third frag there onto Glady, who is on basically 2 HP. He's gonna move his way up to the street, but Neither with... Wow, how they needed to grab that frag. Let's see, where is Neither? Oh, he's in the Double Doors area now with the SMG. It's a 3v3 situation. Five Kings swarming onto the B side. Actually, there's a Five King player standing on catwalk still, and it's Samuel G. Just gonna see if there's anyone rotating in market. Dex with a frag onto Neither is gonna open up the B side even more. Dex with another frag onto CD. There's one more to go, and Dex has spotted him. He's in the spawn area. Dex has the scope out, and wow, nice Deagle frag from Glady there, denying Dex third frag, or even fourth perhaps. He's just gonna jump out on the site with the Deagle. It's gonna be tough. He has two players just shooting at him, and the car is gonna burn anytime soon. There we go, and Samuel G. shooting the car, and the map goes to Five Kings.
So yeah, 2-1 map advantage for Five Kings. This means GRS can pick the map, and as we've said earlier, it is going to be cross. So it's time to win a knife, maybe. This would be good for Gunrunners because they need Stark on attack. But yeah, Dex 27-11, just dominating Gunrunners on this map. Lovely play. Johnny at least got 5 frags back, but this is not enough to play against Gunrunners. Against Five Kings, of course.
So, at what point now are we finding out what map it is? Obviously, it's just, as I've said, that switched on to Crossfire. I think that's a perfect map to go on to now. I'd rather see that as the fourth map here than Backlot, personally. I think it's a more exciting map than Backlot to a certain degree, especially with these two teams. I'd like to see how the SMGs, scopes, and AKs all play together. Equally with the random maze also from Crossfire. I think this could end up being a really great map, and hopefully a little bit closer than the last map. I think last map meant 13-3, was it?
Yes, it was.
It was, and to be fair, you wouldn't expect that, especially against a team like Gunrunners. You'd expect them to get at least 7 rounds against any team, full stop. So, yeah, bit slightly disappointing from Gunrunners in the last map. If they feel a bit more confident here, then I hope they can stick it to Five Kings like they did on Crash. And if they pull this map out, then it definitely sets up a really exciting map on Backlot, and I think that's what all, like myself, you guys, and all the viewers are looking for.
I really hope Gunrunners can stop up right now, because this is going to be desperate, sad, and depressing if Five Kings take a 3-1 after this close first map and not too convincing win on strike. This just felt as, I don't know, like Gunrunners had no idea how to play City Streets, like they never played it. There were no cool executes, no smokes down, no B rushes, no mid controls. It was just nothing. There was this one execute on defense when they wanted to push the market, and Johnny actually threw a nade while running above the market onto catwalk, and he had to jump down because he would have naded himself.
Yeah, he actually got pretty tagged up by his own nade.
Yeah. So that was a cool execute. Glady got two kills, and Johnny would have followed up with two more kills, but no, his nade totally fucked that strat up. So yeah. Keso being deggy. So only waiting for two more players of Gunrunners to ready up, and then we're going to a crucial knife, in my opinion, because attack is, in my opinion, the strongest side on any of the five maps we can see on Call of Duty 4 these days. Alright, let's see this. Going into the fourth map right now. Five Kings leading 2-1. Let's see what's happening. Will Five Kings take the fifth knife in a row? Did you just get kicked, Mac?
Did.
Don't worry about it. Skull getting 3-4 knife kills, finally!
Gunrunners team get a knife.
Even though 5k, Skull team knifed his teammate. But he was just in a mood, in a killing spree, just knifing around all over the place. Killing Relix and Zuma, and neither just stepped in his way for the third kill. That he had to take him down. So, finally. And they're obviously stuck on attack, so hopefully we see some action right now.
Yeah, I think that knife win is a really big knife win for Gunrunners. Every team wants to start crossfire on attack. It always builds a momentum. It's the easier side. The nades are much more easy to land, because on the defensive side, you're much more prone to getting hit by nades as you're trying to throw good nades at the start of the round, certainly. So, yeah, from a fan's perspective, so glad that Gunrunners got this attacking side. Hopefully they can bring that knife round win into a couple of early round wins.
Alright, Keso, how about you take this one?
Absolutely. Well, we said before, Dix is probably going to be strong on Crossfire, so let's check him out, see what he does. He actually needed, though, to grab the first scope frag of the map onto Relax. Samuel G almost gets taken down as well, but yeah, he gets taken down actually. Ooh, Neither with a nice tag onto Dex there. Dex not really sure where Neither shot him from. Bomb is already down on the B plant. And it's gonna be tough for Azuma and Dex to clutch this. Azuma is all the way back behind Kef. And let's spectate. Let's continue with Dex here. It's picked up an AK. Spotted a player. He's gonna have a player right in front of him. And it's Glady who gets the frag onto Dex in the first round. It's a team ace for Gunrunners.
Ace, yeah, absolutely huge round. I wouldn't mind taking this one if that's okay.
Go for it.
I'm going to watch Yanni. He's actually got the bomb here. He's going to be moving towards B. I do enjoy watching Yanni. The way he plays shows best match experience. He gets dropped straight away. So I'm just going to eat my words and shut the fuck up. And another player from Gunrunners going down. Five Kings on a 5v3 situation. Dex looking like he's playing with utter confidence. Niva's the last person that's standing, and he is currently sitting behind the Melons area. And he looks like he's in all sorts of trouble. He looks like he's going to do nothing. He's getting flanked by one of the Five Kings players, and he's probably going to die unless his game sense saves him, which I doubt it's going to at this point. He does get tagged up though, and he knows he's there, and he was unfortunate to land anything, but he's got his scope out, and oh, he comes very close to landing a no scope on Delita, who now appears to be back on his game, which is definitely good on the the 5-king side.
Yep. I'm gonna watch Dex right now because he got a good spawn. He's going for the scope tool, so let's see if he can pick anything up. Nobody's crossing fast. He scope picks out, but he misses the shot. So let's say unfortunately for him, but also unfortunately for neither, as he had a shot to take him out and missed the shot as well. There's a player on A. Let's see what this is. Gladdy is good, good positioning, but he's making sound right now, so they should know he's in there right now. They've got two players in CAF and two players in A, and Gladdy is still just waiting on the A stairs. That was a player just crossing. Oh, Gladdy, I know you just thought about knifing him, but of course he remembered this is a final. And took him out fast. It's down to his 4v3, and Gladdy with a perfect position to hold down the B bomb side from A. Is he going to any CD peak or is he going to stay in? He can't decide, he's just running around and now he wants some frags because it's a 2v4. And decides to go back again as Relax just picked up a frag onto scores. So Relax picked up another, this is not good, but Johnny finally showing up for his team, so it's Relax who needs to find two more kills after his three frags he already made this round. So clutch or kick, as we say, for the ace, but only 8 seconds remaining. He's going for a desperate attempt to defuse, but can't even start to defuse, and Gladdy takes him out.
Alright. Oh, there's the timeout.
Another timeout.
This unexpected.
They're just gonna try to get under the skin of Gunrunners.
The interesting thing about these timeouts is every single time the Five Kings take them, it seems to fuck up the Gunrunners flow of how they're playing. I don't know if you two agree, but every time I've taken them, they win the round straight afterwards. Yeah. From what I've seen so far in the game.
Well, that's the whole point. They're trying to stop the momentum, because once a really good team gets a good momentum, they can just win so many rounds from that momentum. So it's, I mean, it's tactical. I mean, you could argue that it's a dick move from Five Kings, but I mean, it's by the rules, so Gunrunners can do the same.
It's totally by the rules, and like, to be fair, when you're playing in a game of this magnitude, then fuck what the other team thinks, to be fair. You've got to do whatever you can to win. Simple as that.
Indeed. I'm thinking we should go ahead and look at the leader. So he's on top for Five Kings, and he did really well the last couple of games, or matches. Or maps, I mean. And he's going aggressively on the A side here. He's not going to connect with any player in the AL, he's just going to go up top A. So let's switch over to someone with a little bit more action. Actually, let's see here. Relax and Samuel G with a frag each, then neither reply onto Relax. See what neither does. He's just jumping around in the B house looking for peaks. Didn't he spot a player there in the alley? The bomb is dropped on the B site, and Five Kings just playing patiently. Dex looking for the peak onto neither. The leader has a guy in the basement, and he's aware of it, takes down the lady. Now the light area is pretty much opened up, but someone is going to push down bottom A, and it is neither. He gets punished though by Dex, and the last guy standing is CD. He's got the bomb and trying to get the bomb down on the site, but it's not going to happen. He has four Five King players just shooting all over the site, and Dex with the second frag of the round there, shutting down Gunrunners.
Indeed, I'm gonna go ahead with neither here. He's 6-3. He looks like he's playing strong. He managed to block himself there. Isn't gonna see much through the smoke, however, but he's gonna try and bang straight through it. Now I presume he's gonna go for a set nade, looking for a set nade at back A. It doesn't look like he's gonna land onto anything. We've got three players, I believe, on the Viking side that are sitting on the A side, and one player either sitting at CAF or back map. I believe he's at the back of the map. It's probably Dex, possibly. Not sure. No, it's not Dex, it's definitely an AK. So Neva's going to jump on top of the bus. He attempts to jump on the bus and fails to strafe to get on top of it. He's looking top A. They've the team gunners have faked onto the bomb again. They're trying to pick out where Five Kings are, and Neva's trying to get a frag on to whoever's firing any bullets to try and stop that happening. Dex from bottom A gets a fantastic frag onto Neva. We've got Yanni who's gone back across to the light position. I think they're both going to sit there and establish a point on light where they can try and get a couple of frags in. Sko sounded like he was taking some damage, but from the battle bar apparently he's not. So we've got Yanni who's going to look to move to back A, try and get a frag or two. He's jumped around to look from the standard position in A garden where he's found no one. He's got Samuel G in bottom A who's been standing in the same position the whole time. And also managed to pick up a big frag on Relax, who really should not have failed that since he was standing in a standstill. But Yanni ends up going down, and then Azuma ends up clearing up the round and killing Sko. So good round from Five Kings. It looked like it could have turned back round in Gunrunner's favour, but Five Kings bringing out the big plays when it's needed.
Definitely, they're getting destroyed, JRS, after taking the first two rounds, and the timeout again seems to be effective. They didn't pick up a single round and haven't been close to it either, in my opinion. So yeah, these timeouts are really destroying their confidence. Yeah. Really showing nerves.
I think you should watch Glady, who's in a great position top A. I don't believe that Five Kings know he's there, but they're 4-2 up, which is so unfortunate at this point of the round.
Yeah, it's always good to have a player fast in A, but if you allow players to push into garage while you do that, then what's the point of it? As you can see, Glady just dies because he was in a 1v4, so yeah, it's always the decision making, do you hold basement or do you push into A? So maybe communication's not correct, so yeah. Not a good decision this time.
Let's see here. Who do you think we should follow here? Pretty even with the score. CD is struggling a little bit for Gunrunners.
If you want to follow a Five King player, you gotta hurry up.
Yeah, indeed. Let's follow CD here. Let's see if he turns this around. Let's see if he grabs the first frag of the round. It's a really quick round, but he has yet to frag this map. CD, and he's died 5 times. He's got an assist at least, so he's got 3 points. CD is on top of the bus, and he hasn't spotted a player yet this round, which is surprising. Should be able to grab a frag from this position. He's got one more player to go, and he's assumed, and he jumps over the wall and grabs his first frag of the map. Well played by CD, and well played by Gunrunners.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's nice to see at the moment that neither's actually picking up his game as a scope. It's definitely what Gunrunners need at the moment. He's looking to actually take part in duels with Dex, which is great, and he's missed 2 frags, which he pretty much, I think, should have got at that point. He's thrown an aid down the street. He's looking to take control of the bomb and bring it over to the B side, which is the correct thing to do in a minute, but I don't think the Gunrunners are aware that Five Kings have got someone either sitting in bus or somewhere near the bus. I think it is in the bus. That could cause them all sorts of problems this round. And somehow Yanni, with some awesome game sense, has managed to take that player down. So they have controlled the point of B that they want to control. And neither again missing another frag. I mean, he's come so close a few times where he could have made some round-winning frags, and he hasn't done so. And he's allowed Team Five Kings to have their scope essentially call a lot of calls out on the map, and yeah, just another easy round win for Five Kings. So neither, again, as much as he's top fragging, I think he's missing a lot of crucial shots that are costing his team the game, possibly, especially on a map like Crossfire.
5-3 for Five Kings on defense, so even on a heavily attack-based map, they're taking the lead again, so this doesn't look good. This should be the point where Gunrunners should take a timeout, in my opinion. If they lose this round at the latest, but in my opinion it should have been last round already. Let's see if we can take this one, then of course they will not take one, but if they lose it, I really want to see them taking a timeout. But for now, they're leading 4v3, 4v2 now, so it doesn't look like they need a timeout right now. Astralex just picked up another, it's down to 3v2, so Uzuma just hoping anybody would peek out of the B doors, but he's going to have no such luck baiting out a shot, but CDE has full nerves, not even trying to fire off a bullet right there, and still, again, with a second fake, he's not going to do so. Maybe Uzuma spotted him, though, as they're not trying to go in there. So, yeah, and that's it. So, good hold by Gunrunner. So, after planned situation was perfectly played, they stayed in, they kept their nerves, and they filled it up. So, it's a 5-4 again now.
Yeah. Nader with 10 frags, 6 deaths, and Deleter with 10 frags, 5 deaths. For their respective teams. I'm thinking perhaps we should go ahead and follow Samuel G, who's already picked up 2 frags this round. Quick frags, that is, with the AK. Actually, he got taken down by Skull, so never mind. It's just like, next round, let's say a random name and let's follow someone else, because that person is gonna die. Let's see, Neither here is in the B alley door with the scope. Yeah, he has got the bomb as well. Nades are raining in on the B site. There is a lot of... I think every 5-team player is actually on the B side. Neither is trying to get the bomb down, almost gets so the bomb close. Down, but Azuma with the last bullet there takes him down, and it's all up to Gladi and Skull now to do something about this. Wow, Dex was in the ruins there, got taken down. And the last 2 Viking players are on the B side, they are aware of this. Skull is gonna make his way over to the B site, but it's hard to get the bomb down when Azuma is moving freely in CAF. Azuma's gonna... He didn't actually hear him jump on up on the site. Smart play by Gunrunners there. Really smart play. Sko faking it, kills the leader, and Azuma has got 2 players to go through if you want to win this round. Explosives planted. Gets heavily tagged up. Gladi was the one to almost get the frag on Azuma. The bomb is down as well. So now he's gonna have to defuse the bomb as well. Gladi is in top A now, and it's gonna be really hard for Azuma to do anything about this, because Gladi is gonna take him down with the Deagle. There we go, and yeah. Smart play there by Gunrunner, shooting at Azuma and not letting Azuma hear when Sko jumped up on the site. Smart play.
Yeah, I'd actually like to watch CDE here. He's in a position where he needs to pull out something big for his team.
Dex.
Good that I ignored you and watched Dex.
And CD's got it all to do at this point. He's expecting someone to move into the Melons area. I think Five Kings are just going to play very slowly. There's no need to push anywhere and take any unnecessary frags. Gladi or Gladi goes down, whatever you want to call him, and it's a 5-on-1. And I don't believe CDE is in any position to take the round here, and he certainly isn't. I think all that Gunrunners can expect now is a 6-6, and I think they certainly need it if they've got any chance moving into the defensive side.
Dex is on fire right now, so I'm going to watch him. If you're going to repeat that, it was a lovely 3k and was on him the whole time. So the smoke doesn't seem to be down. Look again, the smoke is on top of the balcony, so if Dex would have peeked the L-band again, he would have had clear vision. But this time he decided for the A spray, but in the end gets the frag onto Sko, so easy enough for him. And again, only Johnny remaining gets the frag onto Sam, but it's still 3 players to find with an SMG. He desperately at least needs to pick up an AK, but I don't think Five Kings are gonna do him the favor and let him out of scope house. Nope, Relax does no such thing and shits his head off from basement, so 5-7 advantage on defense by Five Kings.
Yeah, I think at this point the testicles of Five Kings are swelling. They I don't think they're that worried about Gunrunners. I think Crash is, as I said, very much a map that any team can win, and I think Gunrunners have got the experience to win on a map like Crash that's actually very difficult. But I think the individual talent from the Five Kings team has shone through from the maps after Crash. And I think Gunrunners look weaker and weaker as the game's gone by, unfortunately.
Yeah, and
what's your guys' perspective?
As I said before, I think if you look at Crash just generally, I mean, Five Kings wasn't playing as well as they can. And you could really see Gunrunners making some major mistakes in the rounds. As I said, the round where Azuma just like 1v4'd, when everyone was within a square meter of him, and the round where Deleter just jumped around in A house and killing 5 people in the matter of 10 seconds. And I mean, it's just things like that that just can't happen if you want to win maps on this level. And I think, I mean, sure, as you say, it's possible. Crash is a really close map, and you can gather a couple of rounds based on clutches and stuff like that. And I generally think Gunners were playing pretty well on Crash, but as you say, Five Kings just pull their shit together, the other maps, and just prove that they are the better team, I feel like. And yeah, they're playing really confidently, and very, you can really see that they're very experienced.
As I said, I think you can more see is like round by round, it seems to go by individual skill. Like you see people like Samuel G doesn't do anything for two rounds and then brings out a big three man out of fucking nowhere. And then you've got Dex, who's having an absolutely great game. Like, he's been relatively quiet the first two maps and comes onto a scoping map at Crossfire and really dominates. And I was interested to see how him and Neither kind of went against each other this map, and it looks like Dex has prevailed and come on top. So he's really provided his team with the framework that they need to win the game. So
yeah, but yeah. I mean, as you say there, Five Kings, they're basically taking turns doing good rounds, and exactly. I just think that that's just an outcome of having good team play. I mean, wherever it's an outcome of wherever Gunrunners go, Five Kings just adapts, and every player in Five Kings has the individual skill to just shut down a push from Gunrunners, or to shut down, you know, anything that Gunrunners throws at Five Kings. And I mean, it's also, as much as it is an individual effort to do that, it's also a team effort to, you know, all of the information and nades and smokes and cover and stuff like that. So it's I mean, just well played from Five Kings.
Well, that's a problem as well. Are they really throwing something at Five Kings, or just playing random? For me, I didn't see any sick executes as well. I just remember on Crash they had so many cool executes and attack. And now on a map like Crossfire, of course, Johnny and Glady got into A sometimes with the SMG, but is that your execute, sending the SMG into A? I don't know if that's going to be enough, so let's see if Five Kings can do anything better. Since you guys were talking a lot in the break, I'm going to take this one, and it's a timeout.
You're going to do fuck all, there's another timeout here, guys.
But at least it's a tactical this time, it's neither disconnected.
Someone has disconnected, who did?
It's neither, he has 909, yeah. He's going to lose his top fragging spot, so unfortunately for him.
Well, we can hope there's a magic reconnect here. Neither comes in, and
30 bombs still.
Passed in about 17 frags this half. We'll see. But yeah, I think the map's very much still open. It's all going to depend on the first couple of rounds again. Are Five Kings going to come in and just dominate as they have been the last couple of maps, or are Gunrunners going to get down to the 3v3s and sit in properly and stop Five Kings planting? A few big questions there. We'll see as the first couple of rounds open up. Neither's just reconnected here, so I'm presuming they're going to be starting pretty quickly. So Kesso ready up. I presume these guys are going to be ready soon enough.
Oh well. So again, for viewers who just tuned in, this is the fourth map. Five Kings is leading 2-1 on maps. First map was Crash with a double overtime, which Gunrunners won. Then was a close match on Strike, and then they got absolutely destroyed on City Streets, like 13-3. So if Five Kings win this map, they win the finals. But if Gunrunners can come back from this 7-5 disadvantage, they still have a chance in playing the fifth map. So I'm really curious about this one.
Yeah, it's all going to come down to, and I think I've said it once or twice already, is the first couple of rounds. If
five kings, go seven, 9-5 up, sorry, then I think that the game is in pretty dire straits for Team Gunrunners. But Gunrunners certainly have the potential to get a few rounds in. They just need to make sure they don't get hit by nades too early on. And they stop five kings. I think five kings have got the potential to try and do a few fast plants. They need to stop that as soon as possible. So let's see how the first round goes here.
Can I just say something quickly before we begin? The first map crash, I believe it was 17-19 in favor of Gunrunners. Strike was 13-8 for 5 Kings. And then City Streets was 13-3 for 5 Kings, am I right?
Yep, it was, I think.
Alright, take it away.
I'll take this. Yanni's just made an absolutely fantastic frag back. He's naming onto the bomb. He's not going to have any success because I believe five kings are going to sit back and try and get a couple of picks here. So the Team Gunrunners, they have someone sitting in the back of Cav. He doesn't want to die from any unnecessary nades. Yanni has possibly just seen someone in the Melians area, and he doesn't seem to want to peek them from top 8 at least anyway. But he's peeking from wooden. Obviously he has faith in his teammate that is sitting in basement that's going to cover him, but he could possibly get taken out if the five kings player decides to peek. So it's been a fake here. We've got a team member of team five kings in my banana boxes that's been tagged. I think he's just gone down, and then we've got Dex who's sitting in back scope house, who's inevitably going to go down at some point. And CDE takes him out. So exactly the round we wanted to see. I think Gunrunners have started out on the defense very well. Hopefully they can continue this on and get a couple of rounds back in.
Definitely, let's see how the nades are coming in. You've got a nade from Skull onto Cuff, but it didn't land, it was a terrible nade, it landed on the chair next to Cuff, so definitely needs to work on his aim, on his gameplay, and on his nades. So let's see, Johnny got a good spot on A, but there's a player creeping up the wooden stairs, and it is Relax, and he's getting the frag onto Skull, as Dex already got two frags on to Azuma. Okay, a team kill. Did not get that, and onto Bloody, unfortunately, so still a 4v5 and 4v3, sorry, in favor of 5 Kings. Relax is in a prime spot to help his team out, but he's got two players next to him, and Johnny comes flying in, takes him out in the back, but that's all they're gonna get. Yeah.
I was watching Dex that round come out with a few huge kills. It was essentially just great game sense for him there. I believe it's your rank, SO, so please take control.
Yeah. I wanna check out CDE here. He's last time I spectated him, he did a pretty good job on top of the bus, and he's been struggling a little bit here. He's playing kind of aggressively on the cafe area. He's got an SMG pushing right in front of him right now. He gets taken down actually by Yanni, I believe it is. And let's switch it up here. Dex with two frags on Gunrunner players in the A house. Yanni's gonna have to be careful here if he doesn't want to get taken down by Dex. Jax is just running around on the street with the bomb. He has an AK in his hand as well. He's gonna go for the fake. Spots a player in top A. Two versus two, CD and Johnny versus Dex and Samuel G. Samuel G pushing bottom A. He got spotted though by CD, who has made his way towards bottom A. And it finds the frag on Samuel G. Very important kill for Gunrunners. Dex finds the frag on CD though. Is this gonna be the fourth frag and a clutch from Dex? And it is the fourth frag and a clutch from Dex. Wow. And wow, that's just the ninth round for 5 Kings.
Dex, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Is this me coming into this round here? Following that up. Yeah, I'm going to come on to Delita here, actually. He's been a key player for 5 Kings in this match. He's thrown nade into Bialy to stop the push. Gets annihilated from Yanni across the street. So I'm actually going to go back onto Yanni, who's going to control back A. He does have a player slightly pushing him that gets taken out by Gladdy. So it's a 5-on-2 for Team Gunrunners. They deserve this round. I believe they should have taken last round, so thank God that they look like they're going to get this one, make it an 9-7. Let's not rule 5 Kings out by any means. They are a team that can certainly clutch a 5
Dex is still situation. Alive.
And Dex is still alive, as Gotti put in there. Yeah, Dex is playing absolutely fantastic. He's a map that's made for scopes. Dex is now on his own 3-on-1. What gunrunners want to do is just sit in and just find out where he is and not do anything that's going to prohibit them losing the round. But neither manages to get a scope onto him, and I think that he needs to possibly try and go into more 1-on-1 scope battles early in the round if they want to come back into this game.
Yeah, actually gonna watch neither because he got a good spawn. He sees a player crossing, kills Azuma just before the smoke comes in. So nice. Lucky for him, and a good shot as well. Good movement, he moved away, and a good shot on the leader as well. But the bomb is already down, they didn't anticipate that. So it's a 4v2 advantage, but the bomb down. I'm actually gonna switch to Dex because in a bomb situation he can go huge now. He's going in a better position from Scorpos and runs into a nade. He should have just stayed where he was, and Johnny is just going for the defuse. Smart play. Smoke's coming out instantly, nade's coming out, and they're just going for the defuse. Lovely retake.
Yeah. I'm just gonna say here, I'm gonna follow Dex, but I'm not gonna follow Dex. I'm actually gonna follow Azuma. But just to avoid the caster curse, let's see if it works. Okay, Azuma hasn't died so far. he's making his way towards B. Let's see. We haven't followed Azuma actually. He's not doing too well, but he's doing definitely doing his job. He has the bomb and is moving towards the B site. For favor of Five Kings right now, and he's gonna go straight away for the plant without the smoke, without any nades, without anything. Dex and Neither with a frag each. Azuma has the AK as well, and I don't know how he got the bomb down like that. I mean. Wow, nice pre-fair there from Azuma onto CD as well. I mean, gunrunners really have to stop plays like that, and that is just too easy. And nice frag there from Azuma. Fake defuse going down. Jani with the frag on Azuma though. 2v2 now. The bomb is planted. Make that a 1v1. Jani has to defuse this. It's gonna be tough. There's a corpse laying on the site, so you can't really peek over the site. And that's not gonna work out for him probably. No, Samuel G, nice round from him, grabs the 10th round for Five Kings.
Another timeout coming in here.
Well, at least not after GS one round, so.
Well, what is this one about? Jani's not impressed, as you can see. He's saying, guys, what the fuck is going on? Understandably.
I mean,
sorry, misclick coming out from Delita. I'm calling bullshit there. Yeah, Sony G, look, you seem rather mad. Yeah, it seems like he's a bit of a troll, Samuel G, whether he's on the CG.
He's just a cunt. Let's say he's just a cunt.
He does come from the UK, and yeah, a few of us are at times.
I just want to
savory players.
I mean, the last round there. I mean, gunrunners did just can't give up. I mean, I think there were 4 gunrunner players still alive, and they just allowed Azuma without smoke, without anything, just lay down and plant. And I mean, if they want to stay in the game, they just can't allow that to happen. I mean, crossfire 101. I mean, you can't let anyone lay out in the open and plant.
Yeah, I mean, in my eyes, I think Team Gunrunners need to get back to basics. I don't think that Five Kings are doing anything particularly advanced that doesn't allow Gunrunners to just play very basic and just stop bomb plants, etc. So this round, I'm going to follow Samuel G. I believe that he deserves a bit of airtime here. We'll see what he's doing with AK, what nades he's throwing, etc. So he throws a nade kind of down the street. He actually manages to tag someone but doesn't get the kill. I feel like he's stupidly poking where he is right now. So that smoke like me could have dropped him immediately. He gets dropped from basement, but there's a quick reply. Glad he comes on to relax. And there's a 4-on-3 situation for Team Gunrunners here. 4-on-2 now, actually. So we could be looking at a 10-9 situation, which would be ideal. And again, it's Dex. Dex seems to be the last man standing. The last couple of rounds in a row when Gunrunners have been ahead. Well, that's a good or bad thing, we can't really tell. Maybe Dex should be putting himself in more vulnerable positions to try and pick up some kills, but Grimander's sitting in very conservatively. We've got Yanni who's looking at the B door. We've got Sko who's just holding the A guard and he's just going to sit in very casually. And then we've got CD who's holding the B alley. So Grimander's in a particularly strong position to win the round. Dex is going to have to put out something absolutely fantastic. He's looking in the right positions, but in a realistic fashion, he's pretty fucked, to be honest. He hears some fire coming from top A and then gets taken out by CD and B alley. So great round there from Grimander's in my eyes.
Yep, finally not giving Dex any chance to clutch the round. No silly peeks, no early aggression, just waiting for him to make the move on the bomb, so yeah. I'm gonna watch Dex just the first few seconds. He gets tagged up by Neither, so let's move on to Relax, who was AFK. Uzuma is in a B alley, holding B strong for his team so they can move in the bomb. Nothing to see there. CDE in calf just spraying a few bullets onto Light. No, he's just gonna watch it. Samuel G in the meantime is spraying onto the calf position. So nobody is behind the counter to hold off any plant, and Sam G gets the frag on the CDE as well. I'm not even sure if he saw him or just sprayed that position, but I'm sure didn't see anybody. Oh, Lady, good reaction, pushes into B, but it's only going to be two frags because his team just didn't help him at all there. They could have killed Sam G while he was moving into the B alley. But nope, it's not gonna happen. It's 11-9, 5 kings clutching another round for themselves.
Yeah, and it's gonna be one more round and it's match point for 5 kings, I believe.
No, it's not match point, it's coming
up. One more round.
Yeah, but I mean, if they win this round, it's gonna be match point for 5 kings. If they get 12 rounds.
Oh, Zuma, huge kill.
If I'm not mistaken. But yeah, let's see who is alive and who's not. Where's the action? A lot of action on the B side right now. Wall banging going down. The bomb is on B side. The leader actually drops the bomb. Hands it over to Asuma, I believe it is. Who's gonna take over the corner crouch. Smoke's coming in on the site. I don't really know what that smoke was for. But Asuma fakes it nonetheless. And it's not a lot of frags this round, at least not early. And as I say that, the lead goes down, and it's now the odds are even, 4 versus 4. Bomb getting planted.
Again, why?
Wow, Dex with the wall bang.
Seriously.
Wow. What was it? Oh, it was a sumo planted, but Sko got taken down by wall bang. Or what? I don't get anything. Okay, never mind.
that just
looked
COD
weird.
4, bro, that was, to be honest.
Yeah, I don't know. That was just looked weird to me. never mind.
The third plant coming out from 5 Kings with no resist. There were 4 players who were able to spam, spray, and shoot the bomb, but nothing. There was one tag from one bullet, but that's it. You can't win crossfire if you let the attacking players plant that easily. So, yeah, 3 match points for 5 Kings to win this championship of the pay to play season. Season 2, and Dex opening up with the first frag onto Gladi, looking to get some more, peeking into Cuff. Smoke is coming out, he's going for a spam, not getting anything. Looking for any kind of peeks, and Sam G kills Go and A. CDE gets an A frag onto Deleter, but will that be enough? Neither desperately looking for any player. Fortunately, a player in the name of Relax is crossing, but again! The plant is just going down. Jenny gets the frag on Uzuma, but after the plant, this is just too late. We can just watch Dex annihilating them now. As he is close this time, not in the prime spots to hold it off. Jenny kills him. And it's only Samuel G. He doesn't know what the other player is. And that's unfortunately for neither, because if Sam would have just run away into A, this would have been GG. But unfortunately, he thought he was defusing, spraying the bomb, and that was an easy kill for neither. So yeah, a bit of luck, Johnny turning up big, but yeah, this is just terrible to let them plant again.
It is. I mean, that was a really big round. I'm going to go on to Gladi now, actually, just to watch what he's doing with SMG. This is 12-10 match point for 5 Kings. Anything the SMGs do here is going to be crucial. If they get killed by a nade or just by a random AK fire, it could really fuck up the round for Team Gunrunners. So Relax gets a nade onto Yanni, which is not ideal. CDE onto Exuma, so we're on a 4-4 at the minute. Gladdy has managed to pick up an AK, and it looks like both teams are going to be taking things rather slowly. It doesn't look like it's going to be a fast plant from Five Kings, which is great from the viewer's perspective. Neither gets a frag onto Relax, which is awesome, so that makes it a 4-3. Hopefully we're going to see an overtime here, and Gladdy sees someone going to a melon, so he's no doubt going to be calling that. He's expecting someone possibly to push bottom 8, and Sko gets a call onto Deleter, so by all means this really really should be a Gunrunners round, but Vikings have got Dex, who's on fire at the moment. He's ready to slay some dragons, and he could possibly pull out a few frags. So great frag there from Gladdy. They were trying to get the cheap plant just on the edge of bus near the bomb. They didn't manage to get it, and somehow they know that Dex is sitting there near light. They're pre-firing all over the shop, and it's 12-11. This is exactly what we want to see. We're dying to see Gunrunners get the next round. Hopefully Dex doesn't get an early frag, no one gets any early nades, and hopefully this will come into
Come on, Kizo, no shotcasters, girls on Jiraz this round.
Yeah, all right. The last deciding round. Will it go to overtime?
Neither, for fuck's sake.
Yeah. Winning the scope battle, very important in this crucial round.
Oh no,
and,
Dex again.
Dex going huge, Relax with another frag. There's two Gunrunner players left to go for Five Kings to win the championship. And the bomb is almost going down, but Azuma got taken down by CD, and it's now a 3-2. Dex moving towards bomb. Is he gonna plant the bomb and grab all of the frags for his team? Sko with a frag onto Relax. It's now 2-2. This is such a crucial round. Gunrunners need to win this to stay alive in the tournament or in the grand finals. Let's see. Dex he's so certain there's someone on top A, and he's just waiting for them to peek. No peek so far. Gunrunners sitting in. Playing for Gladdy, actually spots one top A, gets heavily tagged up, but the bomb goes down. Samuel G stays alive as well, and it's now gonna be tough for Gunrunners to retake this, as Dex has already made his way back into spawn house. He spots a player in bottom light, misses the shot, and let's see where the other Gunrunner player is. There's one bottom light, he's gonna jump out on the street. Dex spots him, grabs the frag. There's one more to go for Five Kings to win this tournament. He's on the site, and Samuel G gets the frag. That's the 13th round for Five Kings, and they have won the pay-to-play season 2 grand finals.
Good job by Five Kings. Not as convincing as last season, but in the end, 3-1 was close in crossfire. Unfortunately for GRS, I couldn't finish it off, but yeah, congratulations. I will try to get both teams and TeamSpeak for an after-match interview, so hang on, guys, you can still analyze. I will try to organize this.
Awesome. Yeah. I think we'll agree. I think the best team won today. I think Gunrunners did put up a good fight, especially on Crossfire, but they got outclassed on Strike and on City Streets especially. So I don't think there's any complaints about who won. I think the best team to play Five Kings were Gunrunners today, and I think the Five Kings have established themselves as essentially the best team in COD 4 currently at the moment. I think they might have some troubles with Team Ancients next season if me and Gesso give it a go. But if not, if I can carry on playing with Team Ace and I keep dropping like 45 bombs with Turtle and carrying those guys, then maybe we'll cause some problems as well. You never know. But it was a deserved win overall.
Definitely.
It'd be very nice to get some of the players in just to chat to them about the game. I think parts of it were very intense, and we did see a display of some particularly great skills in that game. So, congratulations to Five Kings. They've earned their €20 or whatever they won from the whole championship. Yeah, I hope they spend it wisely. I mean, they can send us 5 euros for Shoutcast in the final if they like.
Well, they know donations are up for the next season, so obviously they can donate some money to the prize pool of next season and just win it. So why not?
Yeah, I don't know. It's just like momentarily, Gunrunners are playing really well, but you can kind of sense that they haven't played that much in a long time. I don't know how many games they played. They played like 11 or 12 games the season, and they played it over the course of like a few days. Then they didn't play at all after that. And I don't know. You could just sense that there was some sort of. You could sense that the Gunrunners had been inactive for quite some time, and Five Kings. I mean. Despite Five Kings maybe not playing as much as a team, they play a lot individually, and you know, then it's easy for them to just get back as a team.
And here we have to win a team all coming in together, not sending their captain on his own. So congratulations, guys! Well played.
Hello.
We have Five Kings here, do we?
Come on with the questions. Then I want to go to bed. Let's go.
Yes.
So, how do you feel losing a map in the finals?
Terrible.
Shouldn't have. That was a warm-up map.
Yeah, they play every day. We don't.
I kind of disagree.
Nah, they don't play every day.
They play like, yeah, every they practice 24 hours. Forwards. Yeah.
Anyhow, so what was up with your timeouts all the time? Come on, be real.
It was Sam.
Sam being silly. For the last 3 years, I've done that in every important match, and we've won every important match.
So you're saying this match was important to you?
Of course. Yeah, I wouldn't have quit Counter-Strike otherwise to come back.
Oh, so I'm glad to hear that.
Is it like a momentum breaker?
It was for us.
Well, considering granted... always was cocky in the pre-interview saying that going attack would be easy for them, and then I called a timeout after them winning 3 rounds and we won 9 on the bounce. You could see, okay. Glady as well was saying, oh, it's not doing anything, and then that last half on Crossfire, he was like, what the fuck, guys? And then they won 2 rounds and then we won 6 in a row. So
I think from a caster's perspective, you definitely shut down their momentum once they started picking up some decent rounds. I think the timeouts from you guys were certainly well called. I think Relax, after a very slow start, actually had a really good game in the third map, I believe it was.
We swapped.
I finally had my back.
We saw you swapped up weapons. Yeah, no, you did switch up weapons. It looked like it worked perfectly. I said that you'd do that possibly at the start of the game.
Relax
said,
just
I'm not
doesn't
sure.
feel the AK yeah. that much, and I just give him it's, the SMG then, because I'm okay yeah. with the AK. Not really just, outstanding, but...
I'm not really fragging anymore, since I have to play AK bomb carry on this map, and on this team, and
good,
since
good,
I never really
good,
did that
good,
before.
Good.
And but really the thing is, the last
able
time...
able to frag is a lot of shit.
We met Relax at Brussels when he was playing SMG.
Oh,
considering that, not a lot... We don't really know a lot of people anymore, considering on this game that most people are either... quit onto other things or playing Counter-Strike, you know. that you know, Relax is the only real kind of chance we have really to play, so we all kind
wanted
of
to apologize for my teammates.
Yes, good.
I know they're really toxic and I'm working very hard trying to improve on their behavior.
Right. Okay, well, last words just for you guys. We are tuning off right soon, so whatever you want to say, get it out.
Shout out to my mum, Red Bull and Monster Energy Drink.
don't forget to shout out the winners team.
Let me speak. Winners played amazing this season. I'm
being serious right now.
They
could have made it to the finals if they were even more dedicated. I think they're gonna break some shit next season.
Yeah, they lost this time, but they'll get better one day.
See you, boys.
Some cold words coming in from Five Kings there.
Peace out. Right,
thank you, guys. Have a good night.
See you next season, boys. Peace.
See ya.
Oh, boy.
Okay. That was interesting.
So, look, there's some ammunition there for team winners to come in next season. Hopefully they can train in and cause an upset. I think after slight moments of arrogance there. It'd be an interesting match to see Five Kings lose a map against Winners. But overall, I think the best team won today. And I think it was a very exciting final that everyone definitely enjoyed.
Yeah. And I mean, as I said before, Gunrunners definitely respected those guys. I mean, it's not easy just not playing that much and then coming back and doing what they did. I mean, they still stood up pretty well to Five Kings, so really well played from Gunrunners as well. Yeah.
Yep, heads up to these guys. They've been playing for years and are still on the top level, even though they're aging as we all do. So really cool to see an old players still sticking up to the skill level. But yeah, Five Kings were just looking better today.
Definitely. Any shoutouts before we go, or
shoutouts to all the viewers who view, to all the followers who have followed, and to all the teams who will hopefully play Nations Cup and the third season of the pay-to-play league next season.
Yeah, and is there any info? I saw Mark was linking to a remastered ladder. Is there any info on it, since you're the head admin?
Yeah, I actually gave the remaster topic over to Mark because I have no time and passion to focus on two games at the same time. So I let him take the lead, figure out rules, figure out how we can set up a ladder. So we will try it. I'm not sure, they said they had dedicated servers, but they said this on Black Ops 2 as well, and it was only hosted by Activision or whatever, so we are not quite sure if we can even host matches or play them or shoutcast them or anything, but we will try our best. So if there's any possibility, we will have a ladder on Cybergamer.
Okay, that's cool. Mark? Yeah, or Mac? Sean?
His girl is probably there already.
Yeah.
So we leave him in peace. Any shout outs from you, Keizo?
Shout outs to my followers who tuned in as well, and I mean, a lot of people follow every COD 4 stream, so I don't know. Thanks for everyone for watching, and thanks to all the teams who stayed active during the P2P season and you know, had some good times streaming and playing the games, some drama as well, of course. You can never avoid the drama. It's gonna be interesting to see how many teams turn up for season 3, and yeah, just stay tuned. And I also stream a little bit. My Twitch is KesselMol, so yeah.
Yeah, make sure we're going to write that in the chat once more, his Twitch link, and be sure to follow him, because next season we will see Keizo streaming a lot, and I will co-shoutcast for him if he asks me to. So whenever we see a Nation Cup or pay-to-play ladder match, be sure to follow our streams to get any action right on your screen. So that's it for me from Keizo, and Mac is already hands deep in his girl. So we're gonna say good night for the night. It was a long night for us, almost 4 hours, but yeah, we enjoyed every single bit of it. I hope you did too, and talk to you another time, guys.
Good night.